High school football is on the air. Tonight our broadcast is coming to you from Carencro High School, where tonight it's the quarterfinal round of the Class 5A state football playoffs as the Carencro Golden Bears play host to the Jesuit Blue Jays. Hello once again, everybody. My name is Steve Poliquin, joined by Barry Sherman here at Carencro High School. Interesting matchup tonight, Barry. Maybe a tale of two different teams. You got the high-powered Carencro offense going against the ground attack of the Jesuit Blue Jays.
Jesuit Blue Jays led by Chris Markey coming into tonight. 600 yards already on the playoff season, 1,900 yards going in the regular season. He's a tremendous force. Garen Jim, the Carencro defense, going to have to shut him down.
And, you know, also Jesuit could throw the football a little bit. Anthony Selfo at quarterback, the nephew of Tulane head football coach Chris Selfo.
And the Selfo name, pretty familiar around the Acadiana area. Obviously, the Tulane fans know the name. Anthony Selfo has done a good job. It gives them a little bit of balance, so you can't just cut on the defense for Carencro stopping that run.
Two impressive wins from Carencro to start the playoff bracket. And, you know, when you talk about Carencro, you got to start it off with their quarterback when you talk about their offense, Lucas Taylor.
Lucas Taylor runs the show. He's a guy that can throw the ball. They've done a little bit more of that at Carencro this year, but he definitely can run the ball. He, Quentin Lawrence, and Herbert Hill give them three speed athletes that Jesuit's going to have a hard time stopping.
What's the key to the game, Barry?
I think it's going to be the defense from Carencro. Garen Jim, I talked about him. He's the guy that's going to be focused in on stopping Chris Markey. They shut him down. Carencro should win.
Got a potentially great game here tonight, the quarterfinal round of the Class 5A state football playoffs. The Carencro Golden Bears playing host to the Jesuit Blue Jays. We hope you enjoyed your Thanksgiving Day. We hope that you spend part of your Thanksgiving with us here right on KLAF. Back at Carencro High School, get on their way a little bit early here this evening. Carencro received the opening kickoff. They started off first and 10 at their own 28. Herbert Hill on the first play was stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Lucas Taylor, the quarterback, man in motion, that is Quentin Lawrence. And there is the give to Lawrence going around the right side. He's at the 30 to the 35, up close to a first down, and I think he got it to the 39, and it looks like another few yards are going to be tacked on because of a face pass.
Well, Quentin Lawrence, we've seen it a couple of times this year. We spotlighted Carencro. He's a guy who look at the service Chevrolet offense for Carencro. He'll list Quentin Lawrence as a wide receiver, but he will get the ball on handoffs a lot of times during the night because he does come in motion, go with the flow of the play, takes it to the right side, gets the first down yardage, and then gets some extra yardage tacked on.
So Lawrence picks up 11. Incidental face mask, another 5 yards. That gives the Golden Bears first and 10 at their own 43-yard line. Steve Pelican along with Barry Sherman tonight. Quarterfinal round of the Class 5A state football playoffs. Carencro and the Jesuit Blue Jays. Carencro the one seed, Jesuit the number 8 seed. Single back in the backfield, that is Hill, and he gets the call, and I believe we have a whistle that blew before the play got underway.
Normally when you see that, that means they got a false start or an encroachment play before the start gets started. Dead ball foul.
Dead ball foul. Illegal procedure.
Obviously,
on the offense.
Barry,
5 yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Use their speed tonight. Jesuit's going to try to shorten the game, so to speak, with their power ground attack.
Yeah, you look at their defense. They're going to have to key on a number of players. We talked about Markey, obviously, offensively for Jesuit, but Jesuit really can't key on one player for Carencro. That's going to be important for Carencro to try to use their speed. They've got players like Taylor and Lawrence and, of course, Herbert Hill that have got tremendous speed.
And this is the kind of situation that Jesuit would like to keep Carencro in all night, a first down and 15. Taylor behind center, Hill the lone setback behind him. Lawrence in motion now. He winds up as an eye back. Option play, and Taylor's tripped up right at the line of scrimmage. Looked like the old field monster, field turf monster, got him only a pickup of one. And Barry, that's something I wanted to talk about tonight. A lot of rain in the Acadian area yesterday. Although the field seems like it's in good shape, obviously the rain yesterday plays to the advantage of Jesuit because it might slow down Carencro some.
Well, you got a hard power running team in Jesuit and obviously a speed team that likes to get to the outside in Carencro. So Yeah, you're right, Steve. We're looking at a situation here where if there are any field conditions or any bit of wetness still out there, that's going to hurt Carencro just a little bit.
Second down and 14. Taylor in the shotgun. Rolling left, looking left, throwing left, and has a man. That's Quint Lawrence, complete right at the midfield stripe. And that is a pickup of about, 11 yards on the play. It'll be a third down and 3.
Nice looking play there from Lucas Taylor, rolling to the left. We always talk about the fact that it's difficult throws for a right-handed quarterback to roll to the opposite side. He does it that time, sets up, gets his feet underneath him just enough, get the ball out to Lawrence. Of course, Lawrence, with that speed, defending him on that particular play, had to give him a big cushion and came back to the football. Good pickup.
Taylor, over 1,100 yards passing on the year, over 900 yards rushing, so over 2,000 yards of all-purpose yards for the Carencro cornerback. Looking left again, has a man complete at the 40, to the 35, to the 30, inside the 30, till about the 28-yard line, and that is Tedrick Thibodeau on the big catch and completion.
Well, that time more of a straight drop back for Taylor. Let's take a look at it here on Slimco replay. Out of the shotgun, just takes a couple more steps back, sets up, sets his feet well, a little bit high on the throw, but Thibodeau comes down with the ball, makes a couple men miss, and then good hard running at the end of that play, picks up 20-plus yards. Take a look at Tedrick Thibodeau, the wide receiver.
Officials, stop the clock momentarily. I think the chains are kind of tangled up along the Jesuit sideline. Carencro got here by defeating North Shore in the first round, 49-7. Defeated Destrehan in round 2 last week, 34-13. Jesuit with a 56-31 round 1 victory over St. Amant in round 1, and then got by East St. John last week, 48-40. So while Jesuit has won the first two games, Barry, their coaching staff has got to be a little bit concerned at the fact they gave up 40 points last week to East St. John.
Yeah, it's a defense that has been tested already a couple of games throughout the playoffs. Obviously, they put up great offensive numbers, and you got the feeling tonight that it could be an offensive shootout if Jesuit allows it. They've got to try to shut Carencro down here, and that's going to be a tough task for them.
Still with chain problems across the way.
Just out of the reach of your screen there, looking, everybody looking in at home, top of your screen where the chains are on the Jesuit sideline. They're just now, as you can see the officials moving into your screen there, you got to look at them. Chaining got tangled up trying to move down for the set the first down mark.
When we get back to play, Carencro will have the football first and 10 at officially the Jesuit 27. 9 minutes and 20 seconds left to go in the opening quarter here. High school football action for you on KLAF. Lucas Taylor behind center now. Eye formation as Herbert Hill dots the eye. And there's the give right up the middle to the fullback that time, Jamie Boudreaux. And Boudreaux gets about a yard, if that, before he's brought down after only about a yard and a half gain.
That's probably a play just to try to keep the Jesuit defense honest there. You're not going to see a lot of carries from the fullback in a Carencro offense. And that time, Boudreaux does get one, but not much there.
Second down and 9. Carencro has been effective through the air thus far, as Lucas Taylor is 2 of 2 for 44 yards on the first drive of the ball game. Once again, eye formation as Herbert Hill dots the eye. Give right up the middle again. It's Boudreaux, and Boudreaux is able to get about 5 yards out of it, close to about the 20-yard line. A little bit more room that time for Boudreaux, and he just about popped it.
Well, and obviously now we're looking at something that maybe that the Carencro coaching staff has seen through tapes on the scouting Jesuit. Look at it here on the Slimco replay. Ground level shot here. Just a traditional fullback dive, almost looking like you were set up the option play. Maybe to look at that a little bit later.
Third down, and we'll call it 4. Taylor back to pass, looking right, throwing right, has Thibodeau out there, complete inside the 15, inside the 10, and fights his way to about the 7-yard line. That time, the field conditions played to the advantage of Carencro, as that time the cornerback on the far side, Jason Alvarez, kind of slipped out there, and Thibodeau made an easy catch and picked up the first down for the Bears.
Once again on the Slimco replay here, Taylor, shotgun formation, this time going to the right side, Thibodeau. You saw that Thibodeau, after he caught the ball, he slipped as well, but he was still able to pick up pretty good yardage here inside the 10-yard line. It'll be first and goal for the Bears.
First and goal at the 7.
Look at the Paradise Homes player profile. Lucas Taylor engineering a great drive so far.
Favorite player is Mike Vick. Not a bad guy to pick. First and goal from the 7. Taylor, option play to the left side. He's going to get to the 5. He's going to get to the corner of the end zone and get to about the 1 before he's knocked out of bounds. Run out of bounds by John Giovatella down at about the 1-yard line, but Carencro with a very impressive first drive has it now 2nd and goal inside the 2.
Option play coming right at you here. Lucas Taylor has Herbert Hill behind him, decides to take it himself, almost gets to the corner. He was looking like he was trying to stretch the ball out there to get it across the goal. Of course, the line judge got taken out on the play as well. It'll be 2nd and goal.
Taylor will get behind center this time. Eye formation as Herbert Hill dots the eye. In motion is Lawrence. There's the gift to Hill, right up the middle, touchdown. Now Herbert Hill right over right guard that time, and Carencro with an impressive opening drive has a 6-0 lead with the extra point still to come.
Hey, look at the Paradise Homes player profile of Herbert Hill, 5'6", 155. And his favorite play, I didn't quite catch that. Look at it here on the Slimco replay. Nice blocking at the point of attack for Carencro. Hill didn't get hit until he was in the end zone for the touchdown.
Dusty Castile on to try the extra point. The touchdown comes at the 7:21 mark of the opening period. Snap's good, the hole's good. Castile's extra point attempt is up and that is good. 7 minutes, 26 seconds left to go in the opening quarter. Carencro leading Jesuit 7-0. It's high school football here on KLAF. Brady Dalfrey to kick it away for Carencro. Going to be fielded over there by Stephen Carrier, and Carrier gets over the 15 to maybe about the 17, and that is all. So the Carencro special teams comes up big. And Barry, now we get to take a look at one of the best, if not the best, running back in the state, Chris Marquis of the Jesuit Blue Jays.
Number 28 is his number in the white jerseys for Jesuit, the Blue Jays. As we mentioned in the open, Steve came into tonight having gotten 600-plus yards already in 2 playoff games, 1,900-plus yards during the regular season. Tremendous running back and a guy that obviously Carencro is going to have the key on tonight.
Anthony Selfo, the junior quarterback for Jesuit, he is the nephew of Chris Selfo, who is the head football coach with the Tulane Green Wave. Single setback, guess who? Chris Marquis. And there's the give to Marquis right up the middle, and Marquis hit at the line of scrimmage, but he's able to dive forward for about a yard, and that is all. Guy to take a look at tonight is Chris Brown, the starting tight end for Jesuit. He is number 84.
You look at the service Chevrolet players. You talked about Chris Brown, Steve. He's got another level he's going to be playing at.
He is a commitment to the Tennessee Volunteers, and from what I understand, a outstanding blocker. And they normally run where he is positioned at. Play action pass, Selfo dropping back under pressure, and he's going to be almost dropped, but he flips it to Marquis, who gets the first down and more over the 30, down to the 35-yard line. That time, Barry, Carencro looked like they had Selfo, but an outstanding heads-up play to get the ball to Marquis.
Yeah, it works out just like a shovel pass would work out. Look at it here on the Slimco replay. Selfo, play action pass. Good coverage and good pursuit here up the middle and through the side, but there he just kind of shovels it forward underhand to Marquis, picks up a first down out to about the 35-yard line.
Big first down for Jesuit because it looked like that time that Selfo was going to be dropped for a loss. Eye formation, Marquis dots the eye behind Corey Maul, who is the fullback. Marquis up the middle, little if any room at all, and he's brought down by a couple of Carencro Golden Bears, including number 55, Tim Arsenault.
As well as look like P.J. Edwards, number 41. There's the defense for Carencro from Service Chevrolet. Carmouche, Guillory. You see Garen Jim in the middle. And the cornerbacks and safeties. Defensive backfield will be tested a little bit. Selfo will put the ball in the air.
And Carencro, like they have on offense, a lot of outstanding team speed on the defensive side of the football. 2nd down and 8, officially a pickup of 2 for Marquis. Once again, eye formation, and now we have a flag, and let's see if somebody moved or they just took too much time. Golden Bears are pointing the way up Jesuit.
that penalty flag came from the umpire, Steve, and probably a
dead ball foul. Illegal procedure against the offense. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's going to probably be a legal snap. When you get the umpire coming in and throwing a flag on that, it's not going to normally be your false start. It's going to be something having to do with a snap. And I think you heard it at the tail end there. The referee was telling that they picked the ball up and then put it back down, didn't reposition it, did a false snap.
Justin Harris is flanked to the left side for Jesuit, and to the right side is Ryan Finney. Eye formation, marquee dots the eye. Selfo, three-step drop. Throwing, and that is number 81, Justin Harris, who had it and dropped it. It's incomplete. It'll be second down and about 14 to go.
A little flare out to the left side. He had his man there. Receiver had a chance at making that reception. Look at it here on Slimco replay. Quick drop, about three-step drop. Sets up, flows it out to the left side. Ball floated on him just a little bit. Was high, but definitely a ball could have been received. Didn't come down with it. Bring up second down.
No huddle offense for Jesuit. Of course, there is a difference between a hurry-up offense and a no huddle. Jesuit just seems to run the no huddle and try to keep the opposition from getting the proper defensive personnel into the game. Third down and about 14. Fake the draw play to Marquis. Selfo rolling left under pressure. Intercepted. Intercepted out there by Chris Williams. And Williams is going to bring it back inside the 30 to about the 26-yard line. Exactly what Jesuit did not want to do, Barry, allow Carencro to score in their initial possession and then turn the ball over themselves on their first possession.
Well, let's look at it here, Steve, on the Slimco replay. Selfo under a lot of pressure. That is Waylon Guillory just about to run him down. He makes an ill-advised throw here. Great interception and run back as well for Carencro. They'll get it down inside the 30-yard line, and Chris Williams providing a spark here, but great pressure from Waylon Guillory as well.
First and 10. Of course, the Golden Bear fans definitely in the ball game right now. Ball stationed at about the 27-yard line. There's a pass in the end zone, and that's going to be caught for a touchdown! An unbelievable catch by Quentin Lawrence. It looked like a Jesuit defender had his hands on the football, even though he tipped it momentarily. It looked like James Trasilo tipped the ball, and Lawrence was able to come down with it, a 27-yard touchdown pass from Lucas Taylor to Quentin Lawrence.
Well, you look at your Paradise Homes player profile, and now on the Slimco replay from ground level, Lucas Taylor once again going up top. Like that call offensively from Coach Barus and his staff. Take advantage of the turnover, go right back at Jesuit, hit him hard with a deep pass, and Lawrence gets it from Taylor, touchdown.
That was Alvarez that tipped it for Jesuit. And Lawrence comes down with the extra point. With the touchdown. The extra point by Dusty Castile is up and good. 5 minutes, 9 seconds left to go in the opening quarter. Thus far, it's been all Bears. Carencro lead Jesuit 14-0 here on KLAF. Chris Marquis feeling the kickoff. He gets over the 20 and down to about the 24-yard line before he's brought down by a host of Carencro tacklers, including Wilton Bossier. Yeah, I think it's important right now. It's still very early, Barry. It's important that Jesuit doesn't abandon what they do best, and that's run the football with Marquis.
I don't think they're going to do that, Steve, not this early in the game. They do throw the ball. Selfo has done it all the whole season, but you know they're going to have to come back here to Chris Marquis, the senior, and hit him running the ball as much as they possibly can.
They put the football down at the 25-yard line. First and 10 for Jesuit. Single back in the backfield, that is Marquis. Receiver in the slot, that is Mole. Finney wide to the near side, and out to the far side is Justin Harris. There's the give to Marquis, running right, and gets hit and brought down after about a gain of 3. Bears on the tackle there, number 21, Brian Celestine, and also number 41, P.J. Edwards.
Well, single back backfield there. Deep in the backfield, they hand the ball off to Marquis. Does get outside just a little bit, but never really able to turn it upfield. Good job of stringing it out. Gang tackling by Carencro. They've got more than one player on Marquis at the point of attack, it seems like every time.
Second down and 7 from the 28. Fake to give to Marquis. Play action pass going for Chris Brown and throws the ball behind him. Good pressure there by Brian Celestine. who was able to get some good pressure on Selfo and force Selfo to throw the football behind Chris Brown, and it'll be third down and seven.
Well, as you mentioned, Steve, that is great pressure there. Really, Selfo never able to set himself. He had Brown open, probably would have picked up the first down, but just couldn't complete it to him because he really was throwing that ball on the run.
Brown is the Tennessee commitment. They say he can catch the football as well as block, and they say he is an outstanding blocker. Selfo looking left, throwing left, and incomplete. Pass was intended for number five, Ryan Finney, but Barry, even if that ball is complete, I don't think Finney gets anywhere as a couple of Golden Bears were there ready to make the tackle.
No, good defense there. That was a pretty poor play fake on play action there, Steve. Didn't really draw anybody in. They were well in coverage. And, well, you talk about abandoning the run. They really didn't do it that time. They gave the ball to Marquis in the first down, and they did a good job of selling the run on the second play, had the man open, but good pursuit by Carencro shut him down, and now they get the ball back.
Eric Wilderotter to punt it away for Jesuit. Back to receive Tim Richmond for Carencro. End over end kick. Let's see if he gets a roll. It will get a Blue Jay roll inside the 30. And it's going to be killed on around the 27, 28-yard line. So that's where Carencro is set up shop. We'll take a quick 30-second break. Carencro leading Jesuit 14-0 here on KLAF. Back at Carencro High School. My apologies. I took us to a break too quick. Lucas Taylor while we away. A 17-yard run. There's the pitch to Quentin Lawrence. Lawrence gets to the line of scrimmage, skips the tackler, and is able to pick up 2 yards down to the 47-yard line. So the play that you missed while we were away, Lucas Taylor, 17-yard pickup on a quarterback keeper. That time on the pitch to Quentin Lawrence, and Lawrence picks up 2. It'll be second down and 8.
Almost a forward pass, but the line judge did have his arm back there, so the lateral rushing yardage there for Lawrence. Didn't quite get to the corner as quickly as he wanted to. That was a play, I think, designed to try to get him outside as quickly as he could. Couldn't quite do it.
Tedrick Thibodeau out wide to the far side. In the slot is Chris Jones. In the slot here to the near side, Quentin Lawrence. Now Lawrence in motion. Taylor with the pitch to Lawrence. Lawrence gets to midfield to the 45 and to about the 43-yard line before he's brought down by Jason Alvarez and also Ryan Retief. And thus far, that option has been working to perfection for the Golden Bears, Barry.
Well, Quentin Lawrence, we talked about it. He's listed as a wide receiver. Unfortunately, Carencro looks like he's limping a little bit out there. Look at it there on the Paradise Homes player profile. He's a wide receiver by trade, but it has been a running back over the years, and it will get the ball a lot of times. He's still limping coming out to the near side here.
High formation. The fullback, Joe Jones. The tailback is Herbert Hill. Option play coming to the near side. There's the pitch to Hill. Hill gets to the 40, inside the 40, and carries a man down to about the 35-yard line. So Herbert Hill, who came into the game as the leading ground gainer for Carencro with 946 yards, basically his first carry for positive yardage here this evening.
Well, option play coming back to the near side this time, and Herbert Hill is not a big player, but he is a strong player. When he hits somebody, he can lay a little punishment, and he did it that time, carried a couple guys an extra yard or so.
Carencro doing a good job thus far, I think, of mixing up their plays offensively. Looks like Jesuit is totally off balance, and of course Golden Bears using their speed effectively also. Quentin Lawrence in motion to the near side. There's the gift. The Hill up the middle, has a hole. 30 and slips inside the 30 to about the 26-yard line, but he does pick up a first down and another pickup of close to 8 yards on the play.
Well, I was going to say something before when I saw Quentin Lawrence go down with that little injury. He kind of slipped on that particular play. We saw it again here, and there Herbert Hill slips, trying to do a little bit of a cutback. So the field doesn't look like it's in bad shape, but there is a little bit of moisture still left out there, and it's obviously taken its toll a couple of times.
Yeah, a lot of rain in the Acadiana area yesterday, and the field looks like it's in great shape, but a field can only withstand so much. Give up the middle to Jones, and he's hit right underneath and brought down at about the 26.
Time now for our sideline report brought to you by Landry Harrison Company. For the first time tonight, let's go down to Angel.
Hang on. Before the game, I talked to the Jesuit coach, and I asked him, what's your big plans for tonight? He said, well, I'd like to try to play an errorless game, and I'd like to try to keep Carencro's offense off the field. so far with a 14-0 score, he might want to reconsider that. But, you know, tonight he is having two people out. Scott Netterville, number 97, is out with an ankle injury. And, of course, he wants to see big numbers from Markey. All he wants to do is control the ball and control the game. Back to you guys.
Lucas Taylor tripped up almost immediately at the line of scrimmage, maybe a gain of about a yard to about the 26-yard line on that play.
And, of course, Angel and the sideline report brought to you by Landry Harrison Company, Professional Insurance Corporation.
Mark it just outside the 25. Yeah, Vic Umont, the head coach of the Jesuit Blue Jays, Raging Cajun football fans might remember him. Spent 1 year as the defensive coordinator for the Raging Cajuns back in the 90s.
I think he also went over to Tulane for a year as well.
Three receivers out to the right side. Taylor under pressure. Now he's going to roll left. He's looking for a receiver. Now he's going to tuck it under and run. Gets inside the 20, inside the 15, and a first down to about the 12-yard line. Nothing you could do about that, Barry. Jesuit had that play well defense. That's just great athleticism by the Carencro quarterback, Lucas Taylor.
Yeah, Jesuit had three guys they were going to meet back at the quarterback. The only problem is they didn't quite get him. As Taylor gets to the outside. He's looking downfield for Lawrence, and actually Thibodeau was out there as well. And if he'd have kept the ball a little bit long, he probably could have hit Thibodeau for a touchdown.
And Carencro is going to call a timeout. We'll take a timeout as well. 59 seconds left to go in the opening quarter. Carencro leads Jesuit 14-0. It's high school football here on KLAF. Back to play here at Carencro. First and 10 from the Blue Jay 12 at the Golden Bears. Option play. Taylor hit behind the line of scrimmage and dropped for what I believe is a one-yard loss.
Tonight's KLAF High School Game of the Week is brought to you in part by Neblet Beard and Arsenault, courtesy GMC, and courtesy Hyundai Isuzu.
Sean Cronin on the tackle for the Blue Jays. A loss of one for Taylor and the Bears. Be second down and 11 from the Jesuit 13. In motion is Lawrence. Give up the middle to Herbert Hill. Hill inside the five, fights his way near the goal line. They're going to mark him just short at about the one. It'll be first and goal for Carencro from the Jesuit 1 yard line.
Well, now one, Steve, you're going to give a lot of credit to the offensive line for Carencro. They really opened up a big hole here. From ground level, handoff quickly, Hill hits the hole, and it is a nice size hole, and he won't get hit himself until about 6 yards down the field. He gets through that first tackle, doesn't get in the end zone, but he gets enough for the first down.
Touchdown saving tackle by James Truxillo. They're going to measure this, and from where they have the ball spotted and from where they had the marker's down. I don't understand why they're even measuring it, because it should be a first down by almost a full yard. Unless they just had it wrong to begin with. Yeah, that's an easy first down.
Yeah, they're not really close there, Steve.
Look, I'm not very good at calling these things, but when you see the first down marker at the two and the ball spotted at the one, you just take for granted that it's a first down.
Well, maybe somebody asked for a measurement. I don't know.
Yes, and of course you could do that. Maybe that's just a way to kind of like buy some time so you can call a defensive play, which is maybe something that Coach Vic Umont and company would do. That's the end of the first quarter here from Carencro High School. Carencro leads Jesuit 14-0. You're watching high school football here on KLAF. Back to play here. First and goal for Carencro. Quentin Lawrence at quarterback runs the option and gets in, but we have a flag on the play, and it looks like Carencro is going to be backed up 5 yards. I think there was some movement there.
Yeah, a lot of movement. I saw the defense jump, but didn't look like they came in the neutral zone, so that means they probably reacted to somebody.
Dead ball foul. Legal procedure on the offense. 5 yard penalty, repeat first down.
So Lawrence in the game for the first time behind center. Of course, he has taken some snaps this year. When you have as many athletes as Carencro does, there's more than a couple of them that have the capabilities to play the quarterback position, especially down near the goal line running that option play. This time, Lawrence will be back to his wideout position. He's flanked out wide here to the near side. Lucas Taylor back at quarterback, I formation. Jones the fullback, and Herbert Hill dots the I. Option play, there's the pitch. Hill trying to get to the corner. He's tripped up by Alvarez and brought down at about the 6-yard line. That's a nice open field tackle that time by Jason Alvarez.
Stayed at home on the option play there and looking to turn Hill back in. Hill tried to make a little cut, get away from him, couldn't do it. Nice defensive play. Make the fullback dive here coming at you on the Slimco replay toss. Pretty quickly there and a good job defensively. Staying with the man in the option play. Got to stay in your lanes. Obviously get to the outside, force him back inside. That's where the rest of the pursuit comes defensively.
Second and goal from the 6. Once again, that I formation. Herbert Hill dots the I in motion as Lawrence here to the near side. Give to Hill. Hill gets inside the 5 to the corner of the end zone and the touchdown. 6-yard touchdown run by Herbert Hill, and thus far in the first half of this quarterfinal 5A state playoff game, it's been all Carencro. Herbert Hill with the 6-yard run, and Carencro leads it 20-0.
Taking a look at it here, Slimco replay. Once again, nice blocking at the point of attack. Herbert Hill, about 1-yard line, lowers the shoulder just a little bit, but he got to the corner, to the sticks, into the end zone.
Dusty Castile on to try the extra point. Lucas Taylor holds for him. The touchdown comes at the 11-10 mark of the second quarter. Snap's good, the hole's good. Castile's extra point is up, and that one is also true to form. 11 minutes and 10 seconds left to go in the second quarter. Your score, Carencro 21, Jesuit nothing. You are watching high school football on KLAF. Brady Dowfrey to kick it away. Marquis back deep to receive the kickoff. He feels it at the 1, gets to the 10, to the 15, to the 20, and brought down right at about the 21 by a host of Carencro tacklers. Golden Bears leading this one 21-0 over the Jesuit Blue Jays with 11:02 left to go in the second quarter. Winner of this contest will get the winner of the Hahnville-Higgins game being played at Higgins this evening. Higgins defeated West Jeff in the opening round. Upset there. Higgins is number 29 seed. They won 12-2 in that one. Defeated Old Perry Walker last week, 36-34. Meanwhile, Hahnville with wins over Fountain Blue and Barb. Defeated Barb last week, 28-12. Single setback, that is Marquis. Receiver wide to the near side. That is Justin Harris. The give to Marquis, hit at the line of scrimmage, shakes that tackler, and fights his way forward for about 3 yards.
Tonight's KLAF High School Game of the Week is brought to you in part by Neblett, Beard, and Arsenault. Courtesy GMC and courtesy Hyundai Isuzu.
Marquis, only 9 yards on 4 carries in the early going. You're talking about a guy that had 1,946 yards and 30 touchdowns during the regular season. Now we have an official timeout across the way. And I think they're going to send the
cameraman off the sideline there.
So back up just a little bit.
And get somebody got on the field there on the far side.
Marquis with 669 yards and 2 playoff games, 10 touchdowns. So Carencro's doing a good job of keeping Marquis from getting going in the early going of this one. There's the give to Marquis once again. Has a bit of a hole this time and has about 5 yards close to the 30. This is an important drive for Jesuit, Barry, because they have to get something going here, I think, to kind of gain some confidence and get some momentum going in this contest.
You know, I agree with you, Steve. We were talking about it a little bit there in the break. I'm not sure exactly what the score was, but I know that they were down last week in their matchup versus East St. John, maybe like 21-7, something like that. So they have a habit of coming back, but they've got to get something going fast here. This is an important drive.
A big third down play for the Blue Jays here. Third down and about 2.5 yards. Marquis, the lone setback. He will get the handoff, hit at the line of scrimmage, fights his way forward for about 1/2 yard, but he is well short of the first down.
Well, it definitely didn't abandon the run there. Went to the run 3 times in this series, but the run's going to bring them up short, and they're going to be over 1 yard off the first down marker, so that's going to be a tough thing to try to go for on 4th down.
Yeah, and they have no choice here but to punt the football away. And to punt it away will be Eric Wilderotter. And back deep to receive for Carencro is Tim Richmond. He is stationed at his own 35-yard line. Clock rolling, 9:05 left to go in quarter number two. Not a good kick from Wilderotter. Kind of a, let's see if he gets a good roll. It takes a Carencro hop. It's going to be killed at midfield by Jesuit and number 31, Corey Maul. So good field position for Carencro once again. Right at the midfield stripe with 9 minutes exactly left to go here in the second quarter.
That punt got off his foot like it was going to go far, Steve, but it kind of hung up there. We got a little bit of wind, not much. The flags are pretty much dropped out there. Been down on the field earlier. We definitely had slacked off from what it was earlier today. But that one just kind of hung up there for him and then took a bad bounce, and Carencro got great field position out of it.
Wide to the far side is Tedrick Thibodeau. Wide to the near side, Quentin Lawrence. Fullback is Jamie Boudreaux. The tailback who dots the eye is Herbert Hill behind Taylor. Taylor dropping back to pass, throwing right, going for Lawrence, and that one is broken up and incomplete inside the 10-yard line. Another good defensive play by Jason Alvarez. We've called his name a couple of times. Alvarez a little bit shaken up down around the five, and I hate to venture a guess, but that might be something where he kind of fell on the football and might have had the wind knocked out of him. Hopefully that is all it is.
Well, he's holding his stomach there, so it looks like that could possibly be it. Looking back on the play, though, once again, Carencro going at things very quickly off the change of possessions, the punt this time, just like they did off the turnover before, going up top quickly, looking for Quentin Lawrence. Had good coverage, though, by Alvarez there. Was able to get a hand in and knock the ball away at the last second.
I like the play call, too. You have a 21-0 lead. You have the ball at midfield, good field position. You've been able to gain a lot of yards on the ground, so why not take a shot at things up top? And they went up top looking for the deep man, Quentin Lawrence, and it looks like Alvarez is going to be okay. He's an outstanding defensive back for the Blue Jays. And he's walking off of the field under his own power, so I feel pretty comfortable in saying that we'll probably see Alvarez again.
Of course, he had great coverage there a little bit earlier in one of the drives. So Carencro did a great job open field tackling on Herbert Hill on an option play. So you know he's a good defender. He'll be coming off the play, obviously. Stoppage of clock. He'll have to be off the field for at least one play here. Going back on that incompletion, that's just the first incompletion of the night for Carencro. Lucas Taylor was 4-for-4 up to that point.
Yeah, I think that's a dimension of his game that's very underrated. You know, he's such an outstanding athlete and runner. I think his ability to pass the football is often overlooked, but he can throw the football when need be. I think he's just an outstanding all-around football player. Once again, I formation. Fake the give to the fullback, Boudreaux. Option play. Taylor's going to keep it. Break a tackle inside the 40, and he could go. 30, 20. 10, 5, and touchdown, Lucas Taylor from 50 yards out, and Carencro has blown this one wide open early.
Well, no, Steve, nothing like talking about what a great athlete Lucas Taylor is right before he breaks off a 50-yard run. Let's look at it in a Slimco replay. Just the regular option play, and he does a good job here knowing where the seam is. He makes a man miss, and then after that, he's really got great cutback ability. And once he gets into the open field, they're really not going to catch him.
50 yards on the touchdown from Taylor, his second touchdown of the night, and he's also over the 100-yard mark already in this game. Castile to try the extra point. Snap a little low, and the kick is blocked, and it's no good. The block came by number 30, Jaron Villafana. 8:41 left to go in the second quarter. Carencro extends their lead over Jesuit to 27-0 after the 50-yard run from Lucas Taylor. You're watching high school football on KLAF. Dow free to kick the ball away. He kicks it deep. It's going to be fielded by Marquis as he bobbles it and goes out of bounds inside the five. And, boy, whatever can't go wrong has for Jesuit here so far in the first half.
Oh, that's bad right there for Jesuit. Marquis obviously took his eye off the ball. Bounces off him. Good job, though, by Carencro. Dalfrey, a directional kicking. That's the second time in a row. Yeah. Look at it here on the Slimco replay that he's done a good job of kicking him close to the end zone and also close to the sideline, but not close enough to let it go. Marquis does try to feel it, and then boom, bounces off his hands out of bounds inside the five.
you cannot directional kick any better than Dalfrey has on the last two kickoffs for Carencro. So first and 10 for Jesuit from their own 4-yard line. Marquis, the off-balance eye, gets the call. A little bit of a hole. Skips past a tackler and brought down at about the 9-yard line.
All right, now it's time to once again check in with Angel on our sideline report brought to you by Landry Harris & Company. Angel?
I talked to the Carencro head coach before the game and I asked him, how are you preparing for tonight's game? He said, well, the last time they came up against Jesuit was in 1996 when they beat them 24-14 right before they went to the Dome. I asked him, now how's your practice this week, Ben? He said, the boys have been really relaxed. There's been no school. They've had 3 to 4 hour practices, and then he's let them go home and have some time with their family. Now, they did practice yesterday. Even though the weather was bad, they did do a quick run through inside. Tonight, the boys seem to be relaxed. He says his team is almost at 100%, but one thing is for sure, they sure are playing with at least 100% of heart. We'll send it back to you guys.
Thank you, Angel. Brian Celestine drops Marquis for a 2-yard loss.
Of course, Angel's sideline report brought to you by Landry Harris & Company Professional Insurance Corporation. You got a chance there on the Sunco replay as well to see Marquis drop for a loss to set up another big third down here for the Blue Jays.
I've got Marquis currently, and of course this is unofficial, 8 carries for 19 yards. So the Carencro defense doing a number on Chris Marquis this evening. Clock running, 7:15 left to go in quarter number two. Carencro leading this one 27-0. There's the give to Marquis. And he's hit once again, almost at the line of scrimmage, brought down after only a 1-yard gain. Or just a host of Carencro defenders there. Chris Williams, Garen Jim there, also Wilton Bozier on the tackle. So fourth down, and Jesuit will have to punt the football, and the Golden Bears should have the football again in outstanding field position.
Now, last time they punted from this direction, the ball just didn't go anywhere. Once again, the Carencro defense coming up big. Deep in their own territory, Jesuit not electing to try to throw the ball. 3 straight runs, and Marquis only can get him about 7 yards.
Richmond back to receive the punt from Wilderotter. Wilderotter gets it off the side of his foot, but it's going to take a little bit of a Jesuit hop and bounce to about the 40-yard line. So once again, Carencro with outstanding field position. And well, Barry, this is a playoff game, and anything can happen, but if they score right here, it's going to be awfully difficult for Jesuit to come back in the second half.
Well, they're going to have to really completely abandon the run if they get down another score here. And they can throw the football, but obviously Marquis is their guy they need to go to. You would figure that they would probably start trying to get the ball maybe to him, little passing plays, little screen plays and stuff like that. But a touchdown here for Carencro would really start hammering things home.
They put the football down at the Jesuit 39. So first and 10 for Carencro from that standpoint. Boudreaux, the fullback, and Hill, the tailback in the I formation. Quint Lawrence in motion. There's the give to Hill, and Hill hit at the line of scrimmage and nowhere. Number 99, Marsh Perry there on the tackle, along with number 51 for Jesuit, Baker Jones.
One of the few times tonight we've seen the Jesuit defense really win a battle at the line of scrimmage there. They were able to block upfield, get upfield, and take the blockers for Carencro, pretty much stand them up and hit Hill right at the line of scrimmage.
This is a football clinic, though, that Carencro is putting on here in the first half. It's hard to imagine a football team can play better than this. Complete on the pass out to about the 30-yard line, going to be short of the first down. But still, nonetheless, about a 9-yard pickup on the pass from Lucas Taylor to Quentin Lawrence.
To the right side this time. Look at it here on the Slimco replay. Taylor, two or three steps after he gets the snap. A little hitch pattern pretty much over to the right side. Lawrence makes the reception, gets knocked out of bounds at about the 30, so they pick up 9 on the play.
Third down and a long yard. I formation as Hill dots the I behind Boudreaux. In motion comes Quentin Lawrence. And we have a flag, and normally when they stop the play before it begins, that's normally on the offense. Let's see if there was movement on the offensive front. And there was.
Procedure call. Flag coming in from the head linesman this time, far side.
Yeah. Dead ball foul. Illegal procedure on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
Of course, this is probably four down territory for the Bears nonetheless. Might be a little bit too far to try a field goal here. And, of course, you're not going to punt it from this situation either. So let's see if Carencro runs the option play here. And if they do, then you pretty much know that they plan to go for it on fourth down if they do come up short. They'll shift into the eye once again. Hill will dot it behind Boudreaux, who's the fullback. Thibodeau wide to the near side. Back to pass. Taylor throwing for Thibodeau, and that is going to be incomplete, just off of his fingertips in the end zone.
Boy, and that is a well-thrown ball by Lucas Taylor. Thibodeau could not come up with it, but it was just off of his hands. A nicely done play there. Had double coverage, and he threw it right where it needed to be thrown. Where Thibodeau had the only chance at making the catch. No chance by the defenders, and boy, just off his outstretched arms.
That was Alvarez, who left the game earlier, got the wind knocked out of him, and he was defending on that play. And to be quite honest with you, Thibodeau had a couple of steps on him as a safety, it looked like, was late coming over to help Alvarez. Another fine throw by Lucas Taylor, just barely incomplete. Lawrence wide to the far side, Thibodeau wide to the near side. Out of the shotgun is Taylor. Took it under and run. He will get the first down to the 25 and to the 20-yard line. A pickup of about 15 yards and another Carencro Bear first down.
Well, that's what you got when you got Lucas Taylor back there, the threat of him running the football every time. Good defense here by Jesuit in terms of covering them in, but they can't do it up the field. And once the pocket breaks down, Taylor gets outside, he gets the first down.
I think I told you earlier that Taylor had eclipsed the 100-yard rushing mark. I was adding up his rushing and passing totals unofficially. I got him for 95 rushing yards thus far in the first half. Nonetheless, he is awfully close. I formation, fake to give to Boudreaux. Taylor will keep it, lost the football. It's going to be picked up by Jesuit, and they will have the football at the own 25-yard line as James Truxillo picks up the fumble out of midair and gets it back to the 25-yard line, and Jesuit finally gets a break.
Boy, that was a fumble that came out of there almost like he was throwing the ball to him. It shot out of there. Let's look at it at Slimco replay here. Option play once again. Taylor right there got the arm, came in from a Jesuit defender and just knocked the ball out from behind and just flung it forward.
Eric Wilderotter is the guy that knocked the football loose, and coming up with it was James Truxillo. Let's see if the Blue Jays could take advantage of it here. Sulphur rolling to his left is going to tuck it under and run, get over the 30 and brought down right at the 30-yard line, and he's going to be brought down by number 55, Tim Arsenault. Pickup of only 5 yards. It looked like he was going to have a lot more room to run than that. Second down and 5 now.
A lot of space out there to the left side. Sulphur did get about 5 yards out of the play, but Carencro speed showing there on defense really closed in on him quickly.
Yeah, they have tremendous makeup speed, this whole Carencro team. Three wide receivers to the far side. Selfo will be dropped. Sack time coming from number 45, Garen Jim. Drops Selfo for close to a 10-yard loss.
Well, things just broke down so quickly on Selfo there. You look at the Paradise Homes player profile. Garen Jim, 6'1", 220. With the player Ray Lewis, he is one of the premier defensive players in the Acadiana area. Just a great linebacker.
I like his favorite player because his favorite player plays his position. That middle linebacker spot, of course, there's no better middle linebacker in the entire world than Ray Lewis. Selfo dropping back to pass, looking over the middle, caught and dropped at the first down marker, and I believe that's Finney down at around the 36, and it is. Ryan Finney had his hands on it, and Barry, to be quite honest with you, Selfo's passing statistics aren't great, but his teammates aren't exactly helping him out right now.
No, it's another drop that he's had on the night, Steve, and I've got him down now at 1 of 6. He was got his first completion for 17 yards, and since then he's had 5 incompletions, and actually 4 incompletions and 1 interception.
3:34 left to go in the second quarter. It's blocked. It is blocked by Brian Celestine, and Carencro will have it at their own at the Jesuit 20-yard line. Brian Celestine coming in there, getting a hand on it, and once again, Carencro continues to apply pressure to Jesuit.
Celestine gets in there with a block. P.J. Edwards, number 41, the guy who eventually picks the ball up, is knocked out of bounds. Right at about the 21-yard line, so it'll be a first and 10 for the Bears there. Let's look at it here in the Slimco replay. It's great pit rusher up the middle. Garen Jim was also in on that particular play, and there you see Edwards gets the ball, gets knocked down about the 21-yard line.
So first and 10 from right at the Jesuit 20 comes Carencro. Quentin Lawrence in at quarterback. He will run the option and get tripped up and brought down close to the 15, so a pickup of about 5 for Lawrence on the play. It'll be second down and 5. Clock running now with 3 minutes and 10 seconds left to go before halftime. Carencro leads Jesuit 27-0 and threatening for more here.
You see Lawrence, Quentin Lawrence, number 4, and was in at the quarterback position on that particular play. It's like Lucas Taylor will take back over here, second down.
And Lawrence and Thibodeau will go wide to the far side. It's an I formation. Joe Jones, the fullback. Herbert Hill dots the I. There's a pitch to Hill, and Hill gets a yard, maybe 2, before he's brought down by a couple of Blue Jays, including Colby Bowens on the tackle.
Colby Bowens.
This is a quick toss that time. Had a hold just briefly, though. The Jesuit did a great job of plugging that up very quickly. Linebackers had a great pursuit that time.
That toss right there is a play that the Saints use a lot. If you watch them with Deuce McAllister, that's designed to get the football to the tailback quickly so he has the opportunity to check out the field and make good cuts. Taylor wide to the far side on this play as Quint Lawrence will take the snap behind center. I formation as Hill dots the I. Option play, Lawrence will keep it, get inside the 10, inside the 5, and touchdown. Quentin Lawrence with a 13-yard touchdown run. And with a minute and 59 left to go in the second quarter, Carencro leads it 33-0 with the extra point still to come.
You see Quentin Lawrence, the wide receiver slash quarterback slash running back, this time at the quarterback position, takes the option play, elects not to pitch it, and does a great job cutting back, actually 2 cutbacks there, gets into the end zone for the touchdown.
Go for 2.
Golden Bears will go for 2 after missing their last extra point. Lucas Taylor back in behind center. There's the pitch on the option play to Herbert Hill, and he will get in for the 2-point conversion. And with a minute and 59 left to go before halftime, it's all Carencro this evening. The Golden Bears lead the Jesuit Blue Jays 35-0. After the touchdown run from Quentin Lawrence and the 2-point conversion from Herbert Hill, you are watching high school football here on KLAF. Back at Carencro High School, the kick was in the end zone by Brady Dalfrey, so Jesuit has it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Carencro leading it 35-0 with a minute and 59 left to go before halftime. It's been all Golden Bears in this Class 5A quarterfinal game. Selfo play action pass rolling right, has a man, it's complete to the 25 and to about the 29-yard line. The receiver is Justin Harris.
Well, that's the first completion that Selfo's had since the first pass of the night. Finally gets something going there, positive, at least offensively. About 8 yards on that play.
Second down and about 2. Two receivers to the near side this time. That is Ryan Finney and also Justin Harris. Also a man in the slot that is Marquis. Selfo dropping back, looking left, throwing left, and this ball is going to be intercepted. Intercepted by Wilton Bossier, and Bossier's going to get inside the 30 till about the to about the 29-yard line. Second interception of the night thrown by Selfo, and boy, Carencro has not only done a good job of mixing up plays on offense, but they've also done a good job of mixing up their defense, kind of disguising pass rushes and disguising coverages. And that time, Bossier, it looked like Carencro was in a zone defense that time. Selfo overshot his intended receiver, who was Marquis. Bossier picked it off and raced it back to the Jesuit 28-yard line. So Carencro still with a minute and 38 to do some damage here. Quentin Lawrence wide to the near side. Thibodeau to the far side. Taylor dropping back under pressure. Gets away from a man, but now dropped back about the 42-yard line. Credit the sack for Jesuit. Terrence Ibert on the sack. A loss of about 14 on the play. Clock running with 1:15 left to go before halftime. Into the game, Tim Richmond. He will be at a wide receiver slot for the Golden Bears. Tedrick Thibodeau will be wide to the far side, along with Quentin Lawrence to the near side. It is Chris Jones and also Richmond. Taylor, quarterback draw, gets inside the 40 to about the 38-yard line before he's brought down there. It'll be third down, only a pickup of four. So it'll be third down at about 20 when we get back to play here. Only 42 seconds left to go before the half, and Carencro takes a timeout with only 42 seconds left to go in this half. Winner of this game moves on to the semifinals to take on the winner of Hahnville and Higgins. Hahnville, the number five seed. And if Carencro wins this game and Hahnville wins, the game would be played in Hahnville. If Higgins were to upset Hahnville, and Higgins has done a good job thus far in the playoffs, they are the number 29 seed, the upset four-seeded West Jeff. And they also upset number 20 seed Carver last week. If Higgins is able to pull the upset for the third week in a row, a potential semifinal contest would be here at the open air Crow Dome in Carencro. At the end of half, do not go to a break. We're going to go straight down to Barry. Third down and about 20 for Carencro from just inside the Jesuit 38-yard line. Coming up at halftime, we'll go down to the field. Join Barry Sherman. Sure, Golden Bear head coach Mac Barus very excited about his team's play. I mean, you can't really imagine a football team playing better than what Carencro has in the first half here. Lucas Taylor, option play. There's the pitch to Quentin Lawrence. Lawrence steps out of bounds just inside the 35 to about the 34-yard line. A pickup of about three for Lawrence. It will be fourth down. And this is a situation where you're out of field goal range at the 34. You're looking at a 51-yard field goal attempt, and you're too close to punt the football away. So with only 34 seconds left, Carencro will go ahead and just go for it here. Tedrick Thibodeau wide to the far side, along with Quentin Lawrence to the near side. We have Chris Jones and also Tim Richmond. The lone setback is Herbert Hill, who's stationed right behind Lucas Taylor in the shotgun. Taylor will tuck it under and run. Will be hit at the 35. Skips away from that tackler, but brought down right at the 34, and he is brought down by Sean Cronin. So Jesuit will get the football back, but they only have 25 seconds to do something with it. As a matter of fact, the Blue Jays might just go ahead and hand the football to Marquis and just go ahead and lick their wounds here and go in at halftime trailing 35 to nothing. Carencro's the number one seed. They were definitely the favorite here this evening, but I don't think many people expected this. This has been an onslaught from the Carencro Golden Bears this evening. Cell phone draw play. This is Marquis. 40, 45, midfield, 45 to the 40. That's the biggest gain of the night for Marquis. A 27-yard pickup, and that's going to make his halftime statistics look a whole lot better than what they would normally be. Here's a look at your Slimco replay once again. Marquis running right over left tackle that time. Gets inside the 40 before he's tripped up by Garen Jim. And Jim shows you once again why he's so highly thought of as a linebacker, is because he'll not only come up to the line of scrimmage and pop you, but he also has outstanding speed. Garen Jim is a middle linebacker who certainly hits like a middle linebacker, but he also has the speed of a cornerback. And that time, he was impressive in running down Chris Marquis. Now, thus far, keep in mind this is unofficial. I've got Marquee 11 carries for 47 yards thus far in the football game. That was a 27-yard gain to make his halftime stats look respectable, but the Bears have really done a good job on him. Cell phone pass out to Chris Brown, complete to about the 25-yard line before he's knocked out of bounds. Pickup of about 14 on the play. That is only the third complete pass of the half from Selfo. And Brown with his first reception. Brown is a Tennessee commitment. He will play in Knoxville over the next 4 years for head coach Philip Fulmer. And a lot of people love him, and it's easy to see why. A big guy who can block and catch the football as well. First and 10 for Jesuit from the Carencro 25. 10 seconds left. Pass to Marquee, and Marquee is brought down right at about the 25, and a flag on the play. He was brought down, I think, by Chris Williams. Let's see what the flag is all about. Illegal use of the hands on the Blue Jays, and that will back Jesuit up 10 yards, and now there's only 4.9 seconds left to go before halftime, and really there's only one thing for Jesuit to do here.
On the white, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Jesuit will call timeout. There's really only one thing left for them to do here before the half, and that's just throw the ball up in the end zone and hope that either somebody comes down with the football or there's some kind of a pass interference on the play. They need something positive to happen to them before halftime, something positive to take with them into the locker room at halftime. It's been all Carencro here in this half. Carencro has really come out fired up and ready to play here this evening. Lucas Taylor, Quentin Lawrence, the mainstays behind the Carencro offense has really done a lot of damage. Also, a touchdown from Herbert Hill as well in the half, and Carencro leads this one 35-0. It's like I said, Carencro, the favorite. They're the number one seed. They're playing at home. You definitely have to consider them the favorite, but I don't think anybody expected for them to be leading 35-0 at halftime, which will be the case if Jesuit's unable to get into the end zone on this play. Trips receivers to the far side. Selfold just rear back and throw it deep, and he will throw deep, and that ball's going to be caught for a touchdown. Wow. That would be number five, Ryan Finney, on the 45-yard touchdown reception. 45 yards from Selfo to Finney, and Jesuit does have something positive happen to them before the half. Well, as much as the first half has been a shocker, that's been a shocker as well. 45-yard score, on to try the extra point. Ryan Retief. And the Blue Jays will have some momentum going into the locker room at halftime. However, they still trail by four touchdowns. Snaps good. Holes good. Retief's extra point is up, and that is good. So it is halftime here at Carencro High School. And the Carencro Golden Bears lead the Jesuit Blue Jays 35-7. Carencro sailing right along in this game, and to be quite honest with you, they still are sailing along with a four touchdown lead, but Jesuit finally had something good happen to them right before the end of the half with a 45-yard score from Selfo to Ryan Finney. Let's go down now to the field. Barry Sherman has Carencro High School head football coach Mac Barus.
Barry Sherman down the field, halftime report brought to you by the Man Companies with Coach Mac Barus. And Coach, I know you're going to be a little bit disappointed right there at the end there, a little bit better breakdown on coverage, but overall, first half-wise, you got to be pleased with the way your team playing.
Yeah, it was going pretty good. It was a 14-point turnaround right there, and we should have had more points, but, we're playing pretty well right now. We've shut them down all except that last drive, so we just got to keep playing defense.
Offensively, it really looks like you've been able to work things around that option play tonight, putting Quentin in motion a lot of times, getting him going, and it really looked like it's doing well for you.
Yeah, we've done a few things different tonight than we have so far, and we're trying to, exploit Quentin as much as we can. And it's opened some things up. We just got to keep playing. As you know, they got a good football team. It's a long game.
Obviously, you got to shut Marquis down a little bit. You've been able to do it so far, but he's probably going to be effective something, maybe even in the passing game, maybe in the second half. You think you're going to have to look for him there?
Yeah, I think so. They're going to find some way to get him the ball and get him in the open field. He's a great player, and they need to get him in the open field. They've had a hard time getting him on track so far tonight. But, I mean, we're going to have a ball game before it's over with.
You know, Jesuit is still down 4 touchdowns, Barry, but I have a there's this thing that I have about momentum in sports. I think momentum is very much underrated, and I think momentum is such a big thing in sports. And right now, despite the fact that they're down 35-7, Jesuit has some momentum, and as we talked about earlier, they get the football here first and second half. So if they can maintain that momentum and score on their first drive in the second half, all of a sudden they'll be back in the football game.
35-14, and if they can do it in about, well, let's say 4 to 5 minutes and still have at least half of the third quarter left, you're right, Steve, and they probably think that they're back in this football game. And that, of course, puts the impetus on Carencro's defense to shut them down, because if they can't get anything out of the first drive, then you're really talking about a numbers matter in the terms of the amount of drives that they've got left, because they're going to have to score 4 more times. And once you get past that first drive in the second half, then you're talking about possibly only having 5, maybe 6 more possessions the rest of the game anyway. You're running out of time then.
You know, Coach Mac Barrow's made some comments throughout the course of the week. He was kind of comparing the two teams, and, you know, he kind of said, well, I'll give my team the advantage on offense, which I agree with. And then he went on to special teams and defense, pretty much said that they were even. Coaching, he gave coaching the advantage to Jesuit. Now, of course, you know, a lot of coaches are going to always give the advantage to the other coaches. But, you know, as a football coach, I think Mac Barrow is very much underrated. You know, he took over a program that didn't have a whole lot of success, you know, through the 70s and 80s. And, you know, he really has a juggernaut program right now in Class 5A. And looking at the way his team is prepared to play tonight, I really think you got to give a lot of credit to the coaches, because it looks like Jesuit was just hit with something that they weren't prepared for there in the first half.
You're right, Steve. I mentioned that a little bit in talking to him there at halftime, the fact that we really saw Quentin Lawrence in motion a lot. We saw him in all kinds of different positions scoring with the football. And I think that got Jesuit a little bit off guard.
We've got some first half highlights for you, so let's go ahead and go to them. Of course, Carencro pretty much dominant throughout the course of the first half, and they were able to score basically at will on the Blue Jays. And there's the first touchdown right up the middle, Herbert Hill right over right guard for the first score. That gave Carencro the 7-0 lead. And then, of course, the Carencro defense also played exceptional football throughout the course of the game. There's an interception that time. Chris Williams on the pick of Selfo, one of two interceptions that Selfo threw in the first half. And that set up the second Carencro score of the game. And it was a touchdown pass from Lucas Taylor to Quentin Lawrence on a ball that was actually tipped by a Jesuit defensive back. And Lawrence able to come down the end zone for the score.
Excellent concentration there by Lawrence, taking that pass in for the touchdown.
Yet more Golden Bear highlights. This time Herbert Hill going over right tackle and getting into the end zone for the score. His lone touchdown there in the first half. And here we take a look at Lucas Taylor on the option play. And Taylor's going to break a couple of tackles and run 50 yards for the score. And of course, the Golden Bears just showing you how many weapons they have on the offensive side of the football.
Of course, that Taylor 50-yard run, the kick was blocked there, so it was 27-0. But of course, the Golden Bears were able to tack on one other touchdown and a 2-point conversion.
Option play again, and Taylor's going to have the ball hit from behind. And it's going to be caught out of the air by Jesuit number 83, James Truxillo. And the 14-point turnaround that Coach Mac Barrus was talking about earlier had something to do with that play, although on this play, the punt was blocked by Carencro and picked up at the 20-yard line.
Of course, that was what set up the last touchdown for Carencro in the first half. That was Lawrence on the 13-yard run. As I mentioned, Herbert Hill took in the 2-point conversion to give him the 35-0 lead. Jesuit Corks came back and got that late touchdown.
And of course, yeah, Jesuit scores on the 45-yard touchdown pass from Selfo to Finney to end the half. So it's 35-7. We're at halftime at Carencro High School. Carencro leading Jesuit 35-7. Back with the second half kickoff right after this timeout. It's high school football on KLAF. Back at Carencro High School, the open-air Crow Dome. The Carencro Golden Bears leading the Jesuit Blue Jays 35-7. And Barry, it was a first half that was dominated by Carencro, both on the scoreboard and on the stat sheet.
Yeah, stats brought to you by Service Chevrolet. Of course, the scores. The leading stat, but rushing yards, 184-52. Blue Jays did eclipse Carencro passing yardage with that last touchdown play, but 266-137, your overall total. Of course, two big turnovers for Jesuit, one turnover for Carencro. That pretty much may have kept Carencro out of the end zone one more time. Penalty yardage, not a lot there, but there were a couple of penalties, including some false starts by Carencro that they did a good job of overcoming.
Go ahead and look at the Class 5A bracket while we have a chance here as we're waiting for the Golden Bears to come back on the field. We told you about the top part of the bracket, which is this one. Carencro hosting Jesuit this evening. Carencro with wins over North Shore 49-7 and over Destrehan last week 34-13. Jesuit had a round one victory over St. Amant 56-31 and defeated East St. John last week by the final score of 48-40. Also have Hahnville taking on Higgins this evening. Higgins, the number 29 seed, with two upset wins, defeating number 4 West Jeff in round 1, 12-2, and then winning last week over number 13 seed O.P. Walker, 36-34. Hahnville, meanwhile, they are the number 5 seed in a team that that really a lot of people think is one of the threats in this 5A bracket for the Carencro Golden Bears. Hahnville defeating number 28 seed Fountain Blue 34-10 in round one and defeating the Barb Buccaneers, who, you know, Barb is playing outstanding football coming into the playoffs, and Hahnville took care of them last week 28-12. Once again, if Carencro holds on and wins this game, they would travel to Hahnville and they would host Higgins. So if you're a Golden Bear fan, Golden Bears are definitely pulling for Higgins in that one. Down at the bottom part of the bracket have West Monroe, the Rebels, playing host to Catholic High of New Iberia, a potentially outstanding matchup this evening. Catholic High of Baton Rouge, the number 3 seed. They eliminated number 30 seed Acadiana in round 1, 34-13. Then defeated Airline last week in a tough battle, 37-31. The Rebels of West Monroe, 28-21 victors over number 27 seed Lafayette High in round 1. And then they defeated McDonough 35 last week in impressive fashion, 56-18. That game tonight in Monroe. And down also at the bottom part of the bracket, you have Evangel, the number 10 seed. Evangel, a round one winner over number 23 seed Woodlawn of Baton Rouge, 49-14 in round one, and then struggled a little bit last week, but still came out victorious over Rummel, 7-5. Evangel, I think, seen it a little bit low because of the fact that they played three games against out-of-state teams, so that's the reason why they're number 10 in the power rankings. And then Evangel is at Huntington this evening. Huntington, the number 31 seed. They sprung a couple of upsets. Huntington defeated number 2 seed Sulphur in round 1, 18-7, and then eliminated number 18 seed Ruston last week, 26-7. So, Barry, I think a lot of the Class 5A bracket was caught off guard early on. You had West Jeff losing, the number 4 seed, and you also had number 2 seed Sulphur losing. So, you know, a lot of people say there's too many teams in the playoffs with 32, but you look at a couple of, you know, number 29 and 31 seeds right there, and they advance to the quarterfinal round of the playoffs.
Right, and you got Huntington. We got a score just a few minutes ago. Huntington was down to Evangel at halftime. I don't remember all the different scores. West Monroe was leading Catholic, and Hahnville was over Higgins at halftime. So that's what we were looking at all across the state there. But as you mentioned, Steve, the fact we had a couple of upsets here really played a part in the 5A bracket as opposed to the 4A bracket. Of course, last week we were at St. Martinville. The St. Martinville Tigers were able to come back and win that game 14-13 in overtime. That's a bracket in 4A where everything is going exactly according to plan. You got 1-8, 2-7, 3-6, and 4-5 matchups this week.
And, of course, in Class 3A, you have an outstanding matchup going on tonight between the Turlings Rebels and the Notre Dame Pioneers. I don't know if any team's playing better football in the state right now than Turlings, but you know what? They need to play as good as they have been because, you know, Notre Dame's been undefeated all year, and they're playing outstanding football, and other Acadiana area teams left in the playoffs. You have the Mamou High Green Demons left in Class 2A, and in Class A, you got a potential semifinal matchup next week. Considering they win, the St. Edmund Blue Jays, the number one seed, they're taking on Block tonight. And you also have the Vermilion Catholic Screaming Eagles, who lit up White Castle last week for 72 points.
They had, what, a 44, hung a 44 spot in the second half after giving up, an opening return for a touchdown on the opening kick of the second half. Then they put 44 back up on the board, if I'm not mistaken, the rest of that second half. But, yeah, and the other team that we kind of skipped over there, West St. Mary as well,
yeah.
They're still alive, and another team that has played very, very solid football all year long. Of course, tonight, KLAF High School broadcast, Game of the Week, brought to you in part by Neblett, Beard, and Arsenault, courtesy GMC, and courtesy Hyundai Isuzu.
We're just about all set to start the second half here. Jesuit was ready to go about 15 minutes ago. Carencro a little late in coming out. They took the allotted 20-minute break. Jesuit will be receiving here to start the second half. Chris Marquis is back there deep for Jesuit along with Ryan Finney. And as Barry and I talked about, a very important initial possession of the second half for Jesuit. My belief is that if they have any kind of chance at all to come back and beat Carencro in this game, they need a touchdown on this opening drive here in the second half. Kick off by Brady Dowfrey, and it's going to be deep, and that's going to be a touchback.
It's deep, and I don't think it's playable.
So Jesuit gets the football first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Chris Marquis held to 20 yards on his first nine carries, was able to break off a 27-yard gainer there before the end of the half, so he ended the first half with 47 yards, but that's still well below his average per game, as he was averaging just about 200 yards a contest coming into the game. As a matter of fact, over 200 yards a contest if you add the playoff games. Selfo out of the shotgun. Throwing deep, pass a man wide open, and he missed him. Man, wow. Oh man, somebody blew a coverage, and I'll tell you what, if Selfo hits Ryan Finney, Finney could run backwards into the end zone.
There are breakdowns in coverage, Steve, and then there are breakdowns in coverage, and that one was the latter. There was nobody within, by the time the ball gets there, nobody within about 25 yards of the wide receiver, and it just overthrown.
It was almost like he came off the sidelines during the play. I mean, nobody was near him. That could have been a huge play for Jesuit. So Carencro gets a break. Already Jesuit having to change their game plan here as they went shotgun on the first play. Now Selfo will be behind center with Marquis, the lone setback beside him. There's the give to Marquis. Breaks a tackle at the line of scrimmage to the 25 and gets about 7 yards up to the 27-yard line.
Almost a little bit of a stretch play there, a sprint out by the quarterback, a little bit different than what we've seen. Really, Selfo went far to get the ball off to Marquis. Marquis showing that he had a good break cutback ability.
Look, they're clapping for us.
Not so sure about that.
Third down and 3. I appreciate the welcome here to Carencro High School. Third down and 3 after the 7-yard pickup for Marquis. He is behind the fullback, Corey Maul, in the I formation. Give to Marquis. He has the first down and more as he fights his way near the 35-yard line. Another pickup of 7, close to 8 yards. And Marquis maybe starting to get it going here.
Well, of course, the Jesuit High running game struggled a little bit in the first half behind Marquis. He really kept in check on most of his runs, but that time able to get a little bit of a seam, a little bit of hole up the middle, and break it through for the first down.
We were told an outstanding run-blocking offensive line by Jesuit. They're really schooled at that, and we're seeing it last couple of plays. Little pass play to the tight end on the play. That is Philip Blanchard. and Blanchard gets about 15 yards out of it, close to midfield. So Jesuit has a good opening drive here going in the second half.
Slimko replay here, shotgun formation, and a little tight end drag across the middle coming from the left side of the offensive formation. Catches it going right and beats his man. That was Chris Williams on the coverage there, was able to get away from him and get it for about a 15-yard pickup.
Shotgun formation, Selfo, with Marquis right beside him. And there's the fake to give to Marquis, and Selfo tripped up behind the line of scrimmage. Waylon Guillory tripped him up, and it's a good thing Guillory did, because if Selfo gets by Guillory, Barry, it looks like he has some room to run.
Definitely, Steve. That was a case where the fake was hoping to get Guillory to go with it and let Selfo get outside almost like a naked bootleg back to the near side. Guillory stayed enough at home, was able to get a hand on Selfo and trip him up, knock him down for a loss.
Second down and 11. Two receivers to the near side, two to the far side. Selfo looking left, throwing left, has a man. It is complete. No, he didn't catch it. Referee says he dropped it down at around the 38. It looked like Justin Harris was able to make the catch, but apparently the ball slipped through his arms.
Harris was coming back for that ball, did a good job of getting away from his defender there, came back to the near side, the sidelines closest to the Carencro bench. Let's look at it here on Slimko replay. Selfo had some time set up to the left side. He throws the ball out, and we just can't see the too close for the can't see over the Carencro bench.
Our referee was right there, so credit to him for being Johnny on the spot. Third down and 11. Selfo rolling right, throwing right, and complete, and a nice catch from Chris Brown, and that's right at the first down marker. And boy, it looks like he can't get any closer than that, but from where they're going to mark the football, it looked like he got the first down, but we'll see.
Let's look at it here in Slimko replay. Shotgun formation. And the pressure is going to force Selfo to roll to the right. Throwing on the run. Got the ball up a little bit, but Brown comes back for it. You love your wide receivers and tight ends to come back for the football. And it looks as though they're going to get the first down.
First down just inside the Carencro 40-yard line. 9:53 left to go in the third quarter. Carencro leading Jesuit 35-7 here in this Class 5A quarterfinal state football playoff game. Lone setback, that is Marquis behind Selfo. There's the give to Marquis, running over left tackle, and hello, a couple of Golden Bear defenders there. Number 21, Brian Celestine. And he had help, I think, from Garen Jim.
Number 45, Garen Jim, of course, the guy we talked about in the beginning, going to be an important player and trying to keep Marquis in check, and he was in on that particular play. A little bit of a stretch play once again, running wide to the left side, can't quite get there, and you see Garen Jim, 45, in on the tackle.
Loss of about 2.5 yards on that play, second down and a long 12. Three wide receivers wide to the far side. Selfo throwing complete to Finney. He's hit right as he caught the football, hit from behind by P.J. Edwards. A pickup of about 7 yards down to the 35-yard line. It'll be third down and about 5.
Big hit across the middle there, but a big catch as well. Finney able to hold on to that football and pick up pretty good yardage now, set up about a 3rd and 5 for the Blue Jays.
Anxious to see if they run the football here, because this is 4-down territory for them, and they desperately need a first down. And I wouldn't be surprised if they run the football with Marquis here. They will. A draw play. Marquis skips past a couple of people and gets near the first down. Might be inches short as they're putting the football down right at the 30, but that's a case where that's just a good back, Barry, because Carencro had a couple of guys in the backfield, and Marquis just slipped by them and picked up yards, whereas your average running back would have been dropped right at the line of scrimmage.
You know, showing some strength on that particular run there. He was hit well short of the first down. Now, he didn't quite get it. He's going to be a yard short, but really he picked up 4 yards pretty much on his own.
Fourth down and less than a yard. I called that play right. I'm scared to call another one. What, maybe a quarterback sneak right up the middle with Selfo. No, it's Marquis, hit out the line of scrimmage, but I think he falls forward for the first down. It's going to be close, but from where they're marking it, it looks like he will get just enough to get the first down.
That's a tough play for Carencro there, because the defender came up and hit Marquis plenty enough before, behind the line of scrimmage to take him down short. But he just couldn't wrap him up and keep his forward momentum stopped, and Marquis basically just fell forward after being hit. Let's look at it here on the Slimko replay. That's 55 for Carencro, the man who makes the hit. That's Tim Arsenault. Got the initial hit on him and definitely had him behind the line of scrimmage, but Marquis, a strong runner, was able to fall forward, and he did get enough for the first down.
Boy, and I said barely enough, and I didn't lie to you because that one was barely enough by the nose of the football. Jesuit picking up the first down. 7:55 left to go in the third quarter. Carencro leading Jesuit 35-7. Blue Jays have possession of the football right now. First and 10 at the Carencro 29 officially. Three wide receivers to the near side here. Marquis, the lone setback behind Selfo, who is in the shotgun. Selfo looking left, throwing left, and that ball is going to be incomplete. Intended receiver is Philip Blancher. And he was knocked down as the ball was overthrown, I think, by P.J. Edwards, who was there on the defense.
Edwards able to put in a little blow right there as receiver went up for the ball. Let's look at a Slimco replay here. Ball fluttered a little bit on Selfo, a little bit high, couldn't come down with the reception, as you mentioned. Edwards there, knock him down.
The ball does have the tendency, it looks like, to float on Selfo a little bit. He's been high on a lot of passes. Looking for Marquis, a diving attempt, and comes up short-handed of it as he got his fingertips on the football but wasn't quite able to hold it. It'll be third down and 10.
Well, that's always a tough touch pass for a quarterback to get that receiver coming out the backfield there. Marquis is set up like he's blocking. Now he's going to start swinging out, and right here is where he gets past the defender. The ball is thrown a little bit too far for him to make the reception.
See, that's another pass where he was long at Selfo. Maybe a little bit too much adrenaline here this evening. Looking left on this play, throwing left, has a man, and it is complete inside the 15, down to about the 13-yard line. And that's Philip Blancher, who's been a busy guy here in the second half. That's the third time that Silfo has looked to him here in the half after not looking his way at all in the first half.
Well, that's a nice-looking play there, Steve. Let's look at it at Slimco replay. Gone level here. Once again, Marquis going out to the right side. This time he decides to come back. And Blancher was able to split the defense, gets behind the short man in front of the long coverage man there to make the reception.
I formation, Corey Maul, the fullback. The tailback is Marquis. Receivers to either side. Draw play, there is Marquis. Gets inside the 10-yard line to the 8 and close to the 7-yard line. Once again, didn't look like much of a hole there, but Marquis was able to pick up close to 6 yards on the play.
Well, that's the one-on-one tackle there, but after the hit, Marquis able to kind of fall forward once again, so he's getting pretty good positive yardage here just about every play, whereas he got maybe 1, 2, 3 yards in the first half. He's getting 4, 5, and 6 on pretty much every carry here in the second half.
7 minutes now left to go in the third quarter. Carencro leading Jesuit 35-7, but the Blue Jays driving. Second down and a long 4. There's the give to Marquis. Gets to the 5 and maybe just inside the 5, and he's going to be about a yard and a half short of the first down.
Yeah, he's inside the 5-yard line here, Steve, but I think he's got to get a little bit inside the 4 in order to get the first down. So it should be about a 3rd and 1 here. Just good hard running. Not a lot there, but he's able to get a couple of yardage and set up a 3rd down here in short.
And if they give it to anybody but Marquis, you got a story, because this is obviously 4-down territory, so even if they don't pick it up on 3rd down, they'll try to get on 4th. But on 3rd down and a yard, you give it to your horse in this situation. That is Chris Marquis. He is in the I formation this time behind Maul, the fullback, and the quarterback Selfo. The give to Marquis. He gets to the 3 to the 2-yard line before he's brought down there, but that'll be good enough for a 1st down.
Yeah, he stood up at about the 2-yard line, maybe a little bit inside of that, but that is plenty enough for a 1st down. So it'll be 1st and goal here for the Blue Jays. Look at it here, right at the point of attack. Good job, leg drive. Garrett Jim is the man in there, really, with the impetus to throw him back, but not until after Marquis gets the 1st down.
So 1st down and goal from the Carencro 2 is Jesuit. One thing about this drive, it is eating up a little time off of the clock. Over half of the period already gone. 5:45 now left to go in the third quarter. There's the give to Marquis. Cuts back inside and gets into the end zone for the touchdown. That's the first touchdown rushing of the night for Chris Marquis, who had 40, if you count the regular season and the postseason coming into the contest. A 2-yard run that time. That cuts the lead to 35-13 with the extra point still to come.
Well, Slimco replay here. Ground level right at the sideline. Selfo actually got tripped a little bit trying to make the handoff coming out from underneath center. I didn't know at first whether he was going to be able to make it to Markey on that little stretch type play. He does get there, hands the ball off, and Markey able to get in the end zone with a two-yard run.
That did take off a lot of time off the clock, though. A 6 minute and 20-second drive to start the second half. Extra point from Retief is up, and that is good. So Jesuit chips into the lead a little bit more. 5 minutes and 40 seconds left to go in the third quarter here from Carencro High School. The Carencro Golden Bears lead the Jesuit Blue Jays 35-14. You're watching high school football on KLAF. Kick is deep, and that's going to be a touchback, and Carencro will have it first and 10 at their own 20.
It's time for another sideline report brought to you by Landry Harris & Company Professional Insurance Corporation. Let's check in with Angel.
I'm down in the field with a real celebrity. I have Devon Walker, the Green Bay wide receiver. Now, what brings you to town?
Thanksgiving to see family and friends and, to watch a good football game tonight.
Now, there's a lot of talent on the field tonight. Are you kind of worried about your position?
Well, that's why I'm here. I think I'm doing future recruiting. They got a lot of great receivers that's playing in this game, and this is the future of what football has to offer for the NFL.
Well, we appreciate you taking the time to talk to us, and we hope you the best with the rest of your season.
Oh, it's not a problem. Anytime.
Well, guys, and we have lots of celebrity, lots of action. Carencro tonight is the place to be. We'll send it back to you guys.
Thank you, Angel. While we were away, Jamie Boudreaux was able to pop off a 30-yard run, but he was stripped of the football, and Colby Bowens came up with it, and Jesuit has the football back at midfield.
Slimco replay here. That long run from the fullback dive position, you're not expecting that, but unfortunately for Carencro, the ball came away, and a big turnover here for Jesuit to get the ball back. And of course, thanks to Angel interviewing Javon Walker, the Green Bay Packers, by way of Florida State, brought to you by Landry Harris & Company, Professional Insurance Corporation.
Well, I told you, momentum was a funny thing, and Jesuit has it right now. Pass complete, about a 7-yard pickup that time to Philip Blanchard on the pickup. And, Barry, as good as Carencro looked for the first 23 minutes and 55 seconds of the first half, Jesuit has looked that good here in the second half.
And the funny thing is Carencro really hasn't done that much offensively to really stop anything except Jesuit stopping them. Carencro just stopping themselves.
Third and three. Selfo dropping back, throwing over the middle, complete to Chris Brown. Gets close to the 30. They'll mark him down at about the 31, a pickup of about 12 on the play.
Of course, that's enough for a first down. We'll stop the clock here momentarily. Steve, we mentioned the fact that Jesuit was going to need to score on that first drive and probably score pretty quickly. They've already decided to go into this hurry-up offense now. They know as far down as they've been that the amount of possessions left in this game are a few, so they need to score every time they get it.
Yeah, and to their advantage, they've been running this the whole game, so it's not like they're running a system that they're not familiar with. Draw play Markey. Hole over the 25 down to the 23-yard line, a pickup of 7. And it'll be second down and 3. Yeah, Javon Walker has really represented the Acadian area well. He's come up with some big-time pass catches from Brett Favre. He needs a couple of days like to rest his hands because Favre will definitely fire the ball in there at you.
Yeah, he had a touchdown catch yesterday on the Thanksgiving game.
Second down, and we'll call it a long 2. I formation, there's the give to Markey. Gets the first down as he spins inside the 20, down at about the 19-yard line. A pickup of 4, and Chris Markey up unofficially to 87 yards in the game rushing. Clock running, it's not running now as they stop it momentarily to move the chains. There's 4:01 left to go in the third quarter. Carencro leading Jesuit 35-14.
And I saw it in the Slimco replay there. Not a lot there, but enough for a first down, so Markey gets it. And he's been able to get some stats now underneath his belt with a little bit of wide open type running here.
Fake the give to Markey. Looking over the middle, complete to Markey. A little safety valve pass. Only able to pick up maybe 2 yards on the play out of it, down to the 17-yard line. Selfo up now unofficially 156 yards passing on the evening.
Just a short pickup there. Tim Arsenault, number 55 for Carencro, the man in on that play. Stayed at home, did a good job. A little dump off, a little check off there by Selfo.
Another important drive for Jesuit. I think they have to score a touchdown here to stay in the game. They got a turnover. They want to capitalize on things here. Second down and eight. There's a pass looking for Chris Brown. And did he make that catch? He sure did. What an unbelievable catch from Chris Brown. That's why he's a Tennessee commitment. And he makes a 17-yard touchdown pass from Chris Selfo, who again looked like he overthrew his receiver, but Brown, just a magnificent catch, Barry.
Let's look at it here, Steve. Slumko replay, shotgun formation. He's going to flood a little out in the backwards post pattern. And then you saw it, one hand. He went out with the left hand, was able to get it, control it enough to bring it back in. And, boy, he makes that touchdown reception. And just like that now, 3:13 to go. And tacking on the point, we'd only be down 14 if Jesuit gets the extra point.
Ryan Retief on to try the extra point. Right-footed soccer-style kicker. Extra point is up, and that is good. So Jesuit chips in a little bit more to the Carencro lead. 3 minutes and 13 seconds left to go in the third quarter here from Carencro High School. Your score, the Carencro Golden Bears 35, the Jesuit Blue Jays 21. You're watching high school football on KLAF. Goday kicks it away. Running it back is Wilton Bossier, and Bossier has a hole, 40, midfield, look out, he could go. And Bossier's gonna go 95 yards for the touchdown.
No flags. Well, there's your momentum, Steve.
Wilton Bossier, 95 yards. They kicked it away from Quint Lawrence, but you know what? Wilton Bossier, pretty good football player himself, goes 95 yards for the score, and just like that, the momentum has now shifted back toward Carencro.
Look at it here on the Slimco replay. They take it in right at the 5-yard line, so 95 yards on the return. Gets through one man there, and then really only has the kicker and another guy who had the angle on him. Block right here, takes that man out, and Bossier able to go in 20 yards, last 20 yards, without anybody close.
He had a convoy the last 40. I couldn't have ran the first 60, but I could have ran the last 35. Extra point is up, and that is good by Dusty Castile. And Carencro extends their lead after the 95-yard touchdown run from Bossier. 3 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Carencro leads Jesuit 42-21. You're watching high school football on KLAF. Brady Dalfrey kicks it in the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Jesuit will have it first and 10 at their own 20, and I tell you what, if you're not impressed by the athletes that Carencro has on their football team, you just flat out aren't paying attention. They have so many guys that can hurt you, and we've seen about five or six different ones tonight, Barry.
Well, we've seen Lawrence, we've seen Taylor, we've seen Hill, we've seen Garen Jim, and that was Wilton Bossier now has a 95-yard kickoff return.
First and 10 for Jesuit. They have been able to move the ball, however, in this half. Selfo out of the shotgun. Throwing deep, has a man. Finney complete, 45-40, and down inside the 40 to the 38-yard line. He had a step on Travis Griffin, Finney did, and they made Carencro pay for it. First and 10, Jesuit at the Carencro 38.
42 yards on the pass play here. Selfo, under a little bit of pressure, got it off just in time, one-on-one coverage, and Finney had his man beat, picks up the big first down. Just like that, Jesuit back in Carencro territory.
Ryan Finney, three catches now, 95 yards. Selfo, over 200 yards passing on the evening. Shotgun formation. There's a little swing pass to Marquis, gets to the 35, and run out of bounds, and brought down there by Garen Jim. I'll check it. That is number 14, Wilton Bossier, there on the tackle, about the 34.
Checking the line judge on plays like that, I always like to look at the officials, see where they're how they're marking that. He had his arm back, so he was saying that was a lateral, Steve. So that'll be officially rushing yards here for Marquis. Good pursuit, though. Keeps him down to about a 4, maybe 5-yard gain.
We gave credit to Coach Mac Barrows, and rightfully so at half. Got to credit Vic Umont for making a judge. Oh, great catch, Chris Brown. Picks up about 8 yards on the play. Boy, he has made two unbelievable receptions in the last couple of possessions. This guy is going to be a big-time player at Tennessee.
big target, and that time was able to use his body pretty much to shield him. He had a Carencro player who came over the top looking for the interception, could not make the interception.
Are you serious with that catch? No. I made a catch like that one time, but then I woke up. You know what I'm saying?
Able to pick up the first down here.
First and 10 at the Carencro 26 is Jesuit. Give to Marquis, big hole up the middle inside the 20 and down right at the 20-yard line. The hole closed quick, but he had a lot of room to run through. Actually, they're going to mark it inside the 20, closer to the 19. So that is a pickup of close to 7 yards on the play for Marquis, who is now.
She should be closing in on the 100-yard mark, it looks like.
I've got him at 97 unofficially.
The clock continues to move here.
1:45 left to go in the third quarter. Carencro leading Jesuit 42-21. Draw play. Marquis puts his head down and barrels his way inside the 15, down to the 14-yard line.
That'll be another first down pickup. Stop the clock momentarily there.
Waylon Guillory on the tackle.
Put Marquis over the 100-yard mark, and they'll have a, looks like the Blue Jays will have it first and 10 from about the 14-yard line.
You're not going to keep a great back like Marquis quiet all night. Carencro did such a good job on him in the first half, but, you know, as good as you're going to play, sooner or later a great back will get a few yards on you, and Marquis is showing you what he could do. There's a pass to Brown, complete, and he will get into the end zone for the score. 14-yard touchdown pass from Selfo. That is Selfo's third touchdown pass of the evening, and Brown catches his second touchdown pass of the evening. And once again, Jesuit chips into the lead.
Fakes it to the left side, comes back rolling to the right end. Made the man who had coverage on Brown initially bite and coming up the field. And once he did that, Selfo got rid of the football, found Brown, who was wide open and able to waltz into the end zone for the touchdown.
He was wide open, and Selfo almost overshot him. Another good play, good catch from Chris Brown, his third outstanding catch here of this half. Retief to try the extra point is up, and it is good. So once again, Jesuit chips into the Carencro lead. 1 minute and 19 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Carencro leads Jesuit 42-28. You are watching high school football on KLAF. Sean Godet kicking it is a little short kick, and it's going to be a nice catch that time. Over the shoulder catch by Jamie Boudreau. And what Jesuit was trying to do there, Barry, was just trying to kick it into no man's land. That's a extended version of an onside kick.
Right, Steve. Like to see, though, when teams do that for the return team to just put the arms in the air and ask for a fair catch. Now, obviously, he would have still had to run underneath that ball to make the fair catch, because if it doesn't do it, it's a live ball, but you can fair catch a kickoff.
I think this is only the second play from scrimmage in the second half for Carencro. There's the give right up the middle, and that is either Boudreau or Jones. Get the number when he gets up. That is Jones, Joe Jones, the fullback, able to pick up about 3 yards out of it, down to about the 35-yard line. Be second down and 7. Now, Jesuit just trying to get the football back here. They are back within striking distance as we're now under a minute to play here in the third quarter. They're only down 2 touchdowns, but their defense is going to have to come up big. They have not shown the ability at all this evening to stop Carencro. The only time Carencro has been stopped was by their own doing, turning the football over. Lucas Taylor option play gets hit at the 37, falls forward close to the 40. That is a pickup of about 5 yards on the play, so it'll be 3rd down and 2 as we're at the 32nd mark of the third quarter.
That'll probably be the last play we'll have here of the third quarter, but it's going to set up an interesting play to start out the fourth quarter, Steve, because it's going to be a 3rd and short, probably about 1, maybe close to 2 yards, and it's going to be an important first down pickup for Carencro.
Yeah, they'll go ahead and let the clock run out here in the third quarter, so that will do it. We're through 36 minutes of football, 12 minutes of football left here from Carencro High School this evening. At the end of 3, your score, Carencro 42, Jesuit 28. You are watching high school football on KLAF. We come back. Herbert Hill fumbles the football, but I think the Bears were able to fall back on the football.
Yeah, I think that may have been Thibodeau was able to fall on it, Tedrick Thibodeau. Let's look at it here on Slimco replay, Steve. Once again, Lawrence in motion, hand off the hill, gets hit right there and loses the football. He actually probably was bobbling it from the arm tackle about the line of scrimmage, kind of fell forward, and luckily for Carencro, Thibodeau picks it up and it's far enough downfield for the first down.
Good heads-up play from Tedrick Thibodeau. Just starting the fourth quarter here, Carencro leading Jesuit 42-28. There's the give right up the middle, and another fumble, and I think Jesuit came up with this one. Joe Jones fumbled the football, and Jesuit comes up with it. That is Terrence Ibert coming up with the football, and Jesuit once again has the football in outstanding field position just inside the Carencro 46-yard line. And I talk about momentum often, Barry, but it's definitely in the favor of Jesuit right now.
No, there's no question about that, Steve. It looked like Jones never even had it off of the handoff there. You saw it on the Slimco replay. It almost disappeared as though Jones thought that Lucas Taylor was going to take that ball back as just a fake. He never had control over it on the handoff, and that gives Jesuit another shot here.
You could tell the difference in this Jesuit team the second half as compared to the first just by their mannerisms. They are a confident football team right now. There's a long pass intended for Finney, just overthrown and incomplete. That's pretty good coverage back there by Travis Griffin. As Finney looked like he had about a half step on him, but that's it. And Barry, that's a difficult play for a cornerback when he has no help from a safety. That's pretty good man-to-man coverage all the way down the field.
Well, he had pretty good coverage there, Steve, but that's still a ball that could have been completed. It looked like it faded a little bit on Self, although, or at least it was misjudged a little bit here, because right down here at the last second, you see that was a reach back almost over the back of his shoulder trying to make the reception.
Selfo throwing, intercepted. Garen Jim, 40, midfield, 45, and knocked out of bounds inside the 45 at about the 42. And in big-time games, big-time playmakers come up with the big-time play, and Garen Jim certainly fits the bill.
Look at our player profile from Paradise Homes there. Of course, we said a little bit in the first half, Ray Lewis's favorite player, the 6'1", 220-pound senior Garen Jim, and he had to be the guy that was making the moves and trying to shut down Marquis. And that time he was able to do something coverage out there, made a read on the pass by Selfo, came across the middle, made the interception, got it into Jesuit territory.
If I'm starting a high school football team, he might be my number one pick. A tremendous player, Garen Jim. Toss pitch, Herbert Hill. Gets inside the 40, the 30, the 20, and brought down at about the 19-yard line before he's finally brought down by James Trujillo. And we got a flag at the end of the play, a very late flag. Trujillo came up with the football.
Normally,
but he might be whistled or flagged, I should say, for some kind of unsportsmanlike conduct at the end of the play. Well, there are Jesuit is clapping like it's going to go against Carencro.
Well, that could have been some kind of long clock down fail. Personal foul. Wow. Unsportsmanlike. We heard a little bit there, a little extra from the officials tonight, but they said it was an unsportsmanlike personal foul. So, a live ball penalty there against Carencro after the long run by Hill.
Well, a penalty will push him back 15 yards, so this will be a
dead ball foul, personal foul, unsportsmanlike against the offensive team. 10-yard penalty, first down.
10-yard penalty? Personal fouls are always 15-yard penalties, and it did move it back. He moved it back 15 yards from where the flag was thrown. Now, of course, the thing about that being a dead ball is that it's assessed from the spot all the way back, and it's first down and 10 now for Carencro. It would have been about a first down and 3 if it had been a live ball penalty.
Right, I think he misspoke because they did mark it off 15, as you said, Barry. 10:51 left to go in the contest. Carencro leading at 42-28. Lucas Taylor on the option play. There's a pitch to Herbert Hill. We got a flag coming in. Two flags. I think they are different penalties. One.
Had to be a hold from the referee based on where that was thrown.
Yeah, one undoubtedly I think will be a hold. We'll have to see what the other one is.
He may have had another illegal block he had one in the, probably on the line based on where that first flag was thrown, either on the guard or the center coming out on that play, and then you may have even had an illegal block or a hold on one of the wide receivers blocking out wide. A lot of times you'll see that the wide receiver take somebody down.
two different holding calls, and I'm sure they'll take the one that's closest to the line of scrimmage there.
Yeah, they're just motioning for one, so it probably is two different infractions there. They're just going to take the one, the first one, which was just about at the line of scrimmage.
Jesuit trying desperately to get the ball back here. And, you know, as I said earlier in this half, Jesuit has not shown the ability to stop Carencro for the whole game.
They won.
Yeah, first down. It'll be first down and 20.
Whoa. Blow my ears out with a whistle.
Well, it was a hold. He saw the indication. The referee didn't just give us a call there, but it was a hold.
First down and 20. Jesuit has not stopped Carencro all night. Carencro has stopped themselves a couple of times. Taylor, under all, he's got room to run. He comes back to the near side, to the 40, to the 35.
Oh,
now skips the tackler. Look at this. Look at this. Inside the 30, and he could go. What an unbelievable athletic run by Lucas Taylor.
Oh, my.
34 yards, and they don't come any prettier than that.
Well, we talked about it, Steve, how many athletes Carencro has, and Lucas Taylor is one of the best, and he proves it there. We've seen him earlier with that 50-yard run in the first half, and this time, whoo, man, talk about your cutbacks. Winds up being a 44-yard run, but he goes about 100-plus on this particular run with all the weaving and bobbing and cutting back and forth. We'll get into here on the Slimco replay. That's after the first cutback. Now we're going to go all the way back to the right side where we started things off, and then he's got a convoy down the right side. Quentin Lawrence and Herbert Hill are down there. Make sure he gets in.
Boy, is he an unbelievable athlete. Extra point attempt is up, and that is good by Dusty Castile. 10 minutes and 10 seconds left to go in the football game. Carencro extends their lead once again. They lead Jesuit 49-28. You are watching high school football on KLAF. Brady Dalfrey kicking off, and it goes into the end zone through the hands of Marquis, but he would have fielded it in the end zone anyway, so that'll go as a touchback. Jesuit now will have to pretty much go to the pass the rest of the way. 10 minutes and 10 seconds left, and they trail by three touchdowns, 49-28, after the unbelievable 44-yard touchdown run from Lucas Taylor. This time, Jesuit will have four receivers, two to the near side, two to the far side. Marquis, the lone running back behind Selfo, who's in the shotgun. Hits Marquis to the 25, to the 30, 35, 40, and brought down over the 40, close to the 42-yard line. Garen Jim, along with Tim Arsenault, there on the tackle. They'll mark it down at the 43, so that's a pickup of 23 yards on the play.
Well, it's suspected that at halftime that they would try to get Marquis involved a little bit in the passing game, and you see why it's effective. Just a quick little swing pass to the right side, and once Marquis gets out in the open, he makes things happen. Gets about 23 yards, first down pickup.
Soundfold now unofficially 260 yards passing on the game. Draw play out of the shotgun. Marquis, good yards. Good yardage, I should say. Close to a first down. Looks like a pickup of 9 yards on the play.
Well, from the shotgun formation, always trying to spread the defense out and then throw that little run, that little draw in, inside. That's what they did effective. In fact, Marquis gotten a number of yards out of that particular type of play with really a spread formation, able to come underneath and get good yardage.
What you want to do if you're Carencro is, if Jesuit's going to score, make them use some of the clock here. Don't let them score quick. Pass out. It's a complete for only about a two-yard gain, but it is a first down. Marquis once again on the reception. Tyrone Moore there in the tackle for Carencro. A pickup of two. Another first down for Jesuit.
Of course, that stops the clock momentarily. As you mentioned, Steve, we're talking about a little bit of attrition here because of the fact that you're not going to have a lot of more opportunities, a lot of drives, a lot of possessions left with a 9:04 coming up on the 9-minute mark now as the clock winds.
They put it at the Carencro 46. Once again, two receivers to the near side, two to the far side. Quick slant out here to Finney, tries to skip a tackler and gets over the 45 to about the 43 before he's brought down by Josh Thompson for Carencro.
Well, they try the quick hitch over to the right side with a man out there to block in front of him, hoping almost like a wide receiver screen. He had Brown out in front, but Brown couldn't make a block to take out two guys, and once Carencro got a hold of him, took Finney down for a short gain.
Hey, what, the last two passes aren't going to cut it if you're Jesuit. Able to pick up only 5 yards on two pass completions, and the clock continues to run. Over the middle, incomplete, is intended receiver Philip Blanchard. It'll be third down and about seven. Right now, Selfo unofficially 265 yards passing for Jesuit. Marquis 111 rushing yards unofficially. And Ryan Finney, the leading receiver, with 97 receiving yards. And we got a timeout on the field. So we'll take a timeout as well. 8 minutes and 19 seconds left to go in the football game. Carencro leads Jesuit 49-28. You're watching high school football on KLAF. Back to play on a third down and seven play. Selfo was looking deep for Marquis and nobody was back there. Quentin Lawrence, playing a defensive back for Carencro, got his hands on the football, almost came up with an interception. But it'll be fourth down now.
We did have a flag on the play, Steve. The line judge here on the near side threw a flag at about the 40-yard line. Look at it here on the Slimco replay. Came back a little bit late here, and that's what the play resulted. Lawrence had a chance for the interception, couldn't come up with it. We should get an indication here what the flag is about.
An eligible man downfield. The climb will be fourth down.
Tonight's KLAF High School Game of the Week is brought to you in part by Neblett Beard and Arsenault, courtesy GMC, and courtesy Hyundai Isuzu.
You do that well. I'm proud of you. Fourth down and seven. Selfo rolling right. He's going to tuck it under. He needs to get the first down, and he does. Inside the 35, down to about the 31-yard line. That is a big first down. I'll tell you how big that first down is, Barry. If he doesn't make that, the game's over. With him picking up the first down, at least Jesuit still has a chance.
Got a shot, Steve, because they can get score here. Obviously, they've got to start looking at possibly some onside kicks as well. Selfo had plenty of room out to the outside, just gets out of bounds. But he does get the first down to about the 31-yard line.
First and 10 from the Carencro 31 is Jesuit. Three receivers to the far side, one to the near side. It's Finney to the near side. Marquis out of the backfield. He will make the catch and get only to about the 26-yard line. Three Golden Bears there on the tackle. Travis Griffin, Tim Arsenault, and Garen Jim. And also there is Chris Williams.
Well, the last play that Selfo made was a good play because he got a first down, got out of bounds. But that one was not a good play in terms of trying to conserve a little bit of the clock here, Steve. He picks up about 4 or 5 yards, but clock will continue to run here, take away valuable time for Jesuit.
Yeah, they are taking a lot of time in this drive. Of course, they're down 21 points, 49-28, with 7.5 minutes left to go in the contest. Selfo throwing over the middle, almost intercepted, but caught by Chris Brown, and he will get down to the 2-yard line. Quentin Lawrence had his hands on the football, and Chris Brown came up with a deflection reception and gets down to the 2-yard line.
Boy, and Quentin Lawrence had a chance at an interception earlier. Let's look at it here, Slimco replay. Looked like Garen Jim coming in puts a lot of pressure on Selfo. Probably got rid of the ball a little bit quicker than he wanted to. Ball gets deflected and then into Brown's hands, and he makes it pay after he makes the reception, getting inside the 5-yard line.
Josh Thompson with a touchdown-saving tackle for Carencro. First and goal, though, from the 2. Clock running, 7:05 now left to go in the football game. There is Marquis, and I don't think he got in, and he didn't. Down to the 1, and that's going to take off some more time.
Yeah, it's not as big as getting a turnover there, but a good defensive stop there for Carencro as the clock will continue to run now. A touchdown for Jesuit here just gets him down within 2 scores, and the time on the clock is going to be about 6 minutes or so when this drive is done.
Eye formation, power eye formation. Give is to Marquis, and he gets into the end zone for the touchdown. So a 2-yard touchdown run for Marquis. It's his second touchdown of the night, and touchdown number 42 on the year if you count the postseason. And that gets Jesuit a little bit closer. As I said, certainly you have to consider, you know, Carencro obviously the favorites right now, but the extra point would cut the lead to 14, so at least Jesuit would be within striking distance. Retief on to try the extra point. The touchdown comes at the 6:32 mark of the fourth quarter. And Retief, who's been perfect on extra point attempts tonight, he's 4 for 4, will try to make it 5 for 5. Anthony Selfo is holding. And the extra point is up, and it is good. 6 minutes, 32 seconds left to go from Carencro High School in this Class 5A regional. Make it quarterfinal playoff game. Carencro leads Jesuit 49-35. You're watching high school football on KLAF. I'm expecting an onside kick here from Jesuit. 6:32 left. Let's see if they kick it away. Looks like they're kicking it away. All right, it is an onside kick. It's a little pop thing in the air. Fumble, and let's see if who's going to fall on it. Jesuit has it at the 35. Well, that's something that I think that they needed, Barry, because they haven't been able to stop Carencro on offense, so it's like, why not? You really have nothing to lose in that situation.
Well, there's a case exactly, Steve, where you might as well go for it, and Carencro right here is another example. Why not just go ahead and catch that, go down to a knee, or even fair catch that ball. And he just doesn't come up with it. Had the opportunity, couldn't do it.
Well, Jesuit has an opportunity now. They have the football first and 10 at the Carencro 35 with 6:28 left to go in the football game. The Blue Jays refusing to say die. Boy, they've come back a long way in this football game. There's the give to Marquis. And he breaks the tackle and gets inside the 30, down to about the 28-yard line. That's not good tackling by Carencro. They were trying to strip the ball away, and you got to tackle that guy in that situation.
Tim Arsenault looked like he was the first man in there and just could not wrap him up. Another player came in, as you mentioned, looked like he was just going for the football. Didn't help Arsenault out, and eventually Marquis breaks it and gets good yardage. Second down and 3 here.
So second down and 3, two receivers to the near side, two to the far side. Selfo out of the shotgun, looking right, throwing right, and that pass is complete, and a big hit down. Quentin Lawrence nailed Philip Blanchard, but not before Blanchard was able to pick up a first down down and around the 21-yard line.
Well, a lot of pressure on Selfo that time, including Dennis Carmouche, Darmarcus Carmouche coming in. Put a little pressure on Selfo. Selfo able to buy some time, continue to roll out to the right, hit Blanchard. A big pickup for a first down.
I've had Selfo over 300 yards passing in this game unofficially now. Marquis was the guy that we were spotlighting at the beginning of the game, rightfully so, but Selfo over 300 yards passing now. And he's going to tuck it under and run. This is going to come back. This will be a holding call on Jesuit as Selfo is able to scramble for about 6 yards, but this one is coming back.
Yeah, the referee threw it right in the middle of the pile, and whenever you see that, particularly on a play that lasts that long, you know that it's somebody in the offensive line committed an illegal block, and of course, in this case, it's going to be a holding. It'll bring it back.
Tell you what, though, got to credit the Jesuit Blue Jays. They could have folded it up there.
50 white
against the Blue Jays.
They were down 35-0 in this game with, 5 seconds left to go in the first half, and they scored on a 45-yard touchdown Hail Mary pass at the end of the first half. And if they score a touchdown here, they have a legitimate chance to bring this game possibly in overtime.
Well, we talked about it, Steve, and the momentum going in at halftime was definitely theirs, but the first drive of the second half was the most important thing. When they got that ball and went down the field, drove it down the field, that really put them back in this football game.
Their only problem, however, they're trying to come back against the number one seeded team in Class 5A. Selfo looking for Finney. This will be a pass interference call on somebody. Quentin Lawrence had coverage. Now, this isn't necessarily on the defense. I mean, I didn't see the play down there, but they could call Finney for pushing off. Let's see which way it goes.
Okay, this one, we've got a 6-man crew here for high school. You always see that late in the playoffs. It'll be thrown by one of the back judges, the one on the near side. Let's look at it again on the Slimco replay. May not be able to see the infraction, but a preliminary indication was it was a holding. So that would have been something that was very early on in the play, actually before the ball was actually thrown, given the holding instead of the pass interference. Of course, it'd be pass interference once the ball is in the air.
10-yard penalty, repeat the down.
You see.
So that'll be holding, and that'll be a 5-yard pickup. And
right, the preliminary indication of holding as opposed to 10-yard mark off be 5 yards for the defensive holding, but of course it'd still be a first down.
So it was first and 20. Now with the holding call, it is first and 15. Zelfo will be behind center this time. He's been lined up in the shotgun formation most of this half. Draw play, Marquis gets 5-6 yards down to the 19-yard line.
Well, that one, the clock continues to move here. So we're going to come in up on 5 minutes here. But Jesuit, though, with the turnovers and the onside kick, has been able to kind of lengthen this game here down to a two-possession game. And if they put it in here, down to one possession.
Pickup of 7, so it'll be 2nd down and 8. Fake to give to Marquis. Selfo throwing, and that ball's going to be incomplete. Quint Lawrence again had his hands on it. That was a dangerous pass from Selfo because he threw that into the zone coverage of Carencro's defense, and they had about 5 Golden Bears right around the football.
And the bad part for Carencro there is, Steve, I think Quentin Lawrence may have broken up the interception because based on where that ball was thrown, I think that either one of two players, either Tyrone Moore or even Josh Thompson, may have had a chance at the interception. But Lawrence came across the last second and really kind of knocked that ball away from him because the coverage was very good. You see it there, it was 24.
There's a pass that's going to be out of bounds. Selfo just throwing that one away, and here we go. This will be pretty much the last gasp for Jesuit. If they are to come back in this football game, in my opinion, they have to pick up a first down here on 4th down and 8.
Well, of course, what happened there, we were running the replay of the last play, and they got it and snapped the ball very quickly. What happened is Carencro got a lot of pressure on Selfo there, and Selfo just accepted. It's pretty much threw the ball away on that last play to set up here this 4th down.
4th down and 8. If Carencro gets the football back, they're going to be pretty hard to beat here this evening. Selfo throwing in the end zone, and it's going to be batted around and incomplete. Good defensive play down there by Wilton Bozier. Knocked it away, and Carencro gets the football back.
One-on-one coverage over there. Bozier had his man, did a good job at staying with that particular play. Went up, looking like he was going for the interception. The man from behind went up with him as well. Pretty much knocked each other away from the ball, but it came down incomplete.
And Jesuit has not shown the ability to stop Carencro's offense here this evening at all. So I'm sure Carencro will just keep the football on the ground. As you look at the replay right there, and Bozier with outstanding coverage in the end zone.
Ball knocked away. It would have been a touchdown grab, but good coverage by Bozier.
Herbert Hill dots the eye. Quentin Lawrence in motion. Carencro will probably stick to the ground game here and try to move the chains and run the clock. Taylor trying to get by people, breaks the tackle and gets over the 25 down to about the 26-yard line. Boy, he's a magician, isn't he?
Well, he has shown the fact that he cannot be brought down by just one guy. And Lucas Taylor looked like that was going to be a gain or maybe one, maybe no gain, but he got away from a couple of players there, got it beyond the 25-yard line. Of course, keep the clock moving and be under 4 minutes by the time they snap the ball again. Look at the Paradise Homes player profile of Lucas Taylor.
Well, bad news for District 3-5A teams is he's coming back next year. Taylor with 156 yards unofficially here this evening in the football game. Also 82 yards unofficially passing. So looking at close to 240 yards total offense here this evening from Lucas Taylor. Give right up the middle to Jones. Breaks a tackle and has a hold. 35, 40, 45, over the 45, down to about the 48-yard line goes Joe Jones. A nice pickup that time from Jones. Almost pickup of 20 yards. As a matter of fact, a pickup of about 23 on the play.
Slimco replay here. From ground level, this the fullback dive, and Jones makes somebody miss. Couldn't get the number there, but a Jesuit player had him in the backfield, tried to get him around the legs, couldn't do it. Jones is a load. He gets down the field, gets about 20-plus yards first down. Of course, that stops the clock momentarily, but they'll reset it and wind it now, and it'll be coming up on the 3:15 mark as they snap the ball.
Yeah, the time clock is definitely an ally of the Carencro Golden Bears right now as they lead it 49-35 with 3:15. We'll have to go in the contest. Give to Jones again right up the middle, and Jones has little room that time, but he does fight his way close to about 3 yards on the play. So it'll be 2nd down and 7, and Carencro take their time lining it up, and they'll spend just about all the allotted time that they can. Once that 25-second play clock goes, Taylor will probably call for the snap in between or inside the 5-second mark on the play clock. Let's see. It is down now to 15 seconds. And Taylor is in no hurry, and he shouldn't be. Now he gets up behind center. We're under 10 seconds on the play clock, and it's down to 5 now. And they snap it at 3, and there's the give to Herbert Hill. Hill, 45-40, 35-30. He's gone. 20-10-5, touchdown, Herbert Hill. 49 yards on the play, and Carencro, as a flag comes in late, the Golden Bears are on their way to the semifinals.
We're going to have to see exactly what this flag is, Steve. It came in late, like it may have been something after the play. I'm just not sure. Look at it here on the Slimco replay. One of the officials actually kind of got run over there. He's wondering maybe if we might have an illegal block or something way downfield. Didn't see that call as Hill goes into the end zone. But of course, one of the back judges back there got run over about the goal line by a defender from Jesuit. Flag came in from the line judge very, very late.
49-yard touchdown.
You got a kickoff.
Huh?
You want it on the kickoff.
Can't have it on the kickoff. Larry, they want it on the kickoff, and you can't have it on the kickoff. Can't have it on the kickoff. You got to have it here. You can go half a distance. Dead ball foul.
Dead ball foul. Ball personal foul.
Half the distance is going to be the call. That is, it must have been something that came in right at the end of the play from one of the Jesuit players.
Was that you that wanted it on the kickoff? He told you you can't have it on the kickoff.
No, I don't think he can hear me. We can hear him, but I don't think he can hear me.
49-yard touchdown run from Herbert Hill, his second touchdown rushing of the night. Lucas Taylor and Herbert Hill now between the two of them. 240 yards rushing on the night. On to try the extra point is Dusty Castile. And the extra point is up, and that is good. 2 minutes and 18 seconds left to go in the football game. The 49-yard touchdown run from Herbert Hill just about puts it on ice for Carencro. They lead Jesuit 56-35. You're watching high school football on KLAF. Kickoff is going to be fielded by Marquis down on about the 8-yard line. He gets to the 20, 25, 30, 35. Skips a tackler, but brought down by Tyrone Moore down at around the 39-yard line. So, Jesuit has really no hope other than to just throw the ball down the football field and hope they can come up with a miracle here as they trail it by 21 points, 56-35, with 2 minutes and 10 seconds left to go in the football game. And if somebody would have told me before this game started that there would be 91 points scored in this game, I would have never believed them. A pass complete up the middle to Chris Brown, who has been so impressive in the second half. A 3-yard completion, but that is not what Jesuit wants to do. Carencro will give them that this whole drive as the clock is running, under 2 minutes left now. Officially a 4-yard pickup on the play. 1:50 left to go, and the clock is still running, and Jesuit's not set yet. Selfo, looking left, is going to tuck it under and run this time, and he's going to pick up the first down. He needs to get out of bounds as he gets inside the 35 and does to about the 34-yard line. Yards of total offense in this game for Selfo. Got to credit Jesuit, too. Once again, they made the adjustments at halftime, and their offense has looked a whole lot better here in the second half. The give to Marquis. Flag down, and so is Marquis right at the line of scrimmage. That's an interesting call.
Well, that handoff, you don't know exactly why they're going to go with that, but bad part of that is they're going to get a hold on top of everything here, move everything back, and it's going to be a tough situation here for Jesuit now.
1 minute and 27 seconds left to go in the game. And here's the official call. Or it's not the official. Actually, it is the official call. We just didn't hear him give it. But basically what he said was a holding call, 10 yards on the offense. Holding. See, I could do that too. 1:27 left. Carencro leading Jesuit 56-35. Carencro will move on to play the winner of Hahnville and Higgins in the semifinal round. Hahnville was winning that game 20-14. Last thing that we heard in the fourth quarter. There's a pass downfield, and that ball is going to be, did he catch it? It looked like he caught it on a short hop, but they're going to say the pass is complete to Marquis down there. Big reception down at about the 21-yard line. And I tell you what, that was a nice catch from Marquis if he indeed make the catch. Let's take a look at our Slimco replay here. Pass down the field, Marquis coming back to get it, and boy, he did catch it. Got the hands underneath the football and made a nice catch there down at the 21-yard line. Selfo under pressure, sack time. Selfo sacked by DeMarcus Carmouche back at the 36-yard line. 55 seconds left, and timeout for Jesuit here is Marcus Carmouche, one of the outstanding defensive linemen and defensive players. A senior defensive end comes up with a big sack here, as there's only 56 seconds left to go, and Carencro leading this one 56-35. And you know, we thought before the game started that if Jesuit was going to come up in here and upset Carencro, that the score would probably have to be in the 40s and maybe at the most the 50s, but we knew that there was really no way that they can come in here and get into a shootout with Carencro and come out with a victory, because really, to be quite honest with you, Carencro has too many weapons. I think there's a certain thing too as scoring too quickly. I mean, obviously, if you got a chance to go into the end zone and you're at the 10-yard line, you just don't fall down, you go into the end zone. But nonetheless, I think Jesuit wanted to shorten this game substantially coming into the contest. And they wanted to go on touchdown drives of like 6 and 7 minutes, and that just didn't happen other than to start the second half when they were down 35-7 to begin with. Selfo out of the shotgun, rolling right. Still under pressure, and he's going to throw it, and that ball's going to be complete to Finney, but that's only about a 4-yard pickup, and the clock's going to continue to run. 40 seconds left to go. Jesuit trying to line up quick here. The Carencro Golden Bears will improve to 12-1 on the year. Jesuit will fall to 10-3, and Carencro will move on to the semifinal round. Ashar changed Herbert Hill a while ago. He's actually has 3 touchdown rushings here this evening. Little pass to Marquis, and he's able to pick up about 5 yards out of it down to the 21-yard line. Clock stops at the 14-second mark now, as Jesuit calls for and is granted a timeout at the 14-second mark. But we knew that Carencro would be coming into this game with a lot of weapons, a lot of offensive firepower, but you just don't expect 56 points to be put up in a quarterfinal Class 5A state football playoff game. But you know, Carencro showed you why tonight they are so very dangerous. Now, their defense didn't play as well in the second half as they did in the first half, but of course there might be some reasons for that. First of all, Jesuit's a pretty talented football team. They had the state's leading rusher through the regular season, Chris Marquis. They got a guy that can throw the football in Anthony Selfo. You're not gonna stop those guys the entire game. And then also, I also think that the defense probably wasn't gambling as much in the second half, was sort of playing, not what you would call a prevent defense, but they were given a little bit more cushion on the defensive side because they had a big lead, and that's a smart thing to do. You don't want the opposition to score quick. There's a pass that's complete down around the 12-yard line. Justin Harris with only his second reception of the game. And now we have just under 6 seconds left to go in the football game. Selfo now with over 350 yards passing in the game. Of course, it's going to be all for naught here. There's a timeout for Jesuit, and we might have time for at the most two more plays, but we're probably looking at only one more play here as Jesuit has it first and goal at the Carencro 8-yard line. Carencro dominated this game, and I'm talking about completely dominated the game. The first 23 minutes and 55 seconds, Jesuit showed a little bit of life there at the end of the first half on the Hail Mary 45-yard touchdown pass to end the first half from Anthony Selfo to Ryan Finney. And then they were able to score the first drive of the second half, so they were able to get a little close here. They made a run in the second half, but congratulations to the Carencro Golden Bears that they'll move on to the semifinal round. Selfo looking in the end zone, throwing for Brown, touchdown. Chris Brown with a 7-yard touchdown catch. That is his third down, his third touchdown catch of the evening. And for Selfo, that is four touchdown passes on the night. So the extra point is still to come. And of course, the only thing that matters here is the final score, as Carencro now leads it 56-41, and this will be an untimed extra point is what it is. As the clock shows no time on the clock, and this will be the last play of the year for Jesuit. Retief on to try the extra point. And Selfo bobbled the snap. Now he's going to throw it in the end zone, and it's caught and dropped. Had a man wide open, dropped the football in the end zone, and that's going to do it. The Carencro Golden Bears advance to the semifinals of the Class 5A LHSAA High School Football Playoffs as they defeat the Jesuit Blue Jays by the final score of 56-41. Impressive performance here from Carencro this evening. I'm sure Coach Mac Barus not overly excited at the fact that his defense gave up that touchdown there in the first half, and I'm sure he'll point out some things that they did wrong in the second half, but you know, Carencro defeated a good football team here this evening. And Carencro is still the team to beat in Class 5A. In my opinion, they've been the team to beat all year. And they showed why here this evening, as an impressive offensive performance and a dominating defensive performance throughout most of the first half catapulted the Bears to the 56-41 victory. Down on the field, Barry Sherman has a victorious Carencro head football coach, Mac Barus. Let's go down to the field of Barry and the coach.
Barry Sherman on the field, post-game interview brought to you by the Man Companies with Coach Mac Barus. And Coach, 56 points on the board. I know you have to be happy with that. Offensively, you really did a good job tonight in pretty much all phases.
You know, wow, what can I say? I told you at halftime we had to keep playing hard. And I mean, you know, at this stage of the game, everybody's battling to keep playing every week. And they did a great job in the second half. They made some good halftime adjustments, and we didn't counter them the way we should have. And they just gave up on their running game and started throwing it every down and no huddle offense, and it opened things up for them. I thought they did a good job of adjustments at half. I was proud of our kids, though. We kept battling, and we did what we had to do to win the thing. But, you know, wow. I mean, that's all I can say.
In a game like this, there's so many different plays, but I got to look back to that Garen Jim interception. I thoroughly think with the momentum at that point, that had to be huge for y'all.
I'm glad you can remember that one. I do now, but, I mean, there were so many big plays in the game and so many things. Yeah, and that kind of took their momentum away. I thought the kickoff team would stop the momentum, but it didn't, and we just kept putting the ball on the ground. They got the onside kick, and we just kept letting them hang around, and luckily, they never got within seven. That would have been dangerous, but the hell of a high school football game.
Absolutely, Coach. Just talk a little bit about Lucas Taylor. He just had a magnificent day out there.
Yeah, we've been waiting on Lucas to get back to normal, and he really did a good job directing our offense. He makes very few mistakes, and when he has a chance to make the big play, he gets it. And he's a great football player. It looks like he's playing like he was early in the season right now.
All right, Coach, congratulations on the win. Good luck against Hahnville next week.
Thank you all. I appreciate it.
That's Coach Mike Barus from Carencro. Of course, Carencro now advancing on to the semifinals, taking on Hahnville. We just heard they won their game tonight versus Higgins, so Carencro will be on the road. Golden Bears 56-41, your final. What an absolutely great high school football game. Of course, your post-game report brought to you by the Mann Companies. Ben and David Mann, they've got Pontiac, they've got Buick, and they've got Saturn. Have they got a deal for you? You bet. Go and see them.
Thank you, Barry. Thank you, Coach. Once again, final score here from Carencro High School this evening. The Carencro Golden Bears advance to the semifinals of the Class 5A state football playoffs as they down the Jesuit Blue Jays 56-41 here in the quarterfinal round. We will take a break, come back, or wrap it up from the Open Air Crow Dome right after this on KLAF. Back at Carencro High School, where the Carencro Golden Bears have defeated the Jesuit Blue Jays 56-41 in the quarterfinal round of the Class 5A state football playoffs. Great game all around for the Golden Bears, and they hang on for the 56-41 victory. Players of the game, Barry.
Okay, your Slimco players of the game. Lucas Taylor, of course, on offense, quarterback for Carencro. Defensively, got a lot of tough decisions with a score, 97 points. But Garen Jim did have a good game. We spotlighted him in the beginning. He came through in the clutch, really, with that big interception.
And as far as for the play of the game, we had a tough time deciding that, too. You know, you had Chris Williams came up with a big interception for Carencro in the first half, actually on the first possession that Jesuit had. But our play of the game tonight, maybe one of the most beautiful plays I've seen all year, was the 50-yard touchdown run by Lucas Taylor that basically put the game on ice for the Golden Bears. And we're going to go ahead and go to that play here momentarily and see Lucas Taylor here with one of the more pretty runs you're going to see all year.
Of course, brought to you by Moss Honda, our play of the game. Lucas Taylor rolling out to the right side. He will come all the way back over to the left side. Make a couple of guys miss here on the cutback. And then he decides, well, you know what? There's plenty of open space all the way back on the right side. In fact, he'll get a couple of blocks downfield from Quentin Lawrence, and Herbert Hill are right there out in front of him, number four and number two. And for your Moss Honda play of the game, Lucas Taylor just had a tremendous game. You heard Coach Barrows talk about it, and that was one of them. Just a 44-yard run officially on the stats, Steve, but he went about 100-plus on that run.
And I think that's one of the few plays where every defensive player missed on the play. It was just it was unbelievable. A great win for Carencro tonight, 56-41. And, of course, there you see our key player of the game here, brought to you by Mellow Jar, the original Cajun coffee. And Chris Williams came up with that big play there right at the end, or should I say on the first Jesuit drive of the game, Barry, where Williams was able to intercept the ball, and that really turned the momentum in Carencro's favor.
It did. It really got him off to that big start, Steve. So it's kind of difficult to get a key player in the game like this, but we're going to go all the way back to the beginning, and Chris Williams, the linebacker for Mellowjoy, going to give him the key player of the game. Of course, that's brought to you once again by thanks to Mellowjoy Coffee.
Carencro once again wins over Jesuit tonight, 56-41. Barry, I enjoyed it working with you. It's been a pleasure.
Absolutely, Steve. Appreciate you being out here tonight. I enjoyed working with you as well. And couldn't ask for a better football game. You heard Coach Barrows talk about it with a great high school football game.
Once again, great job by the guys in the truck. Want to thank them and want to thank you. It's been a great night of high school football. Once again, Carencro defeats Jesuit here in the quarterfinal round by the final score of 56-41 for Barry Sherman. And for Angel and for our guys in the truck, for our entire crew, my name is Steve Poliquin. Until next time, so long, everybody.